desert bus.
Hello, procrastinators, and oh god, here we go. Welcome to Desert Bus. This is the ultimate simulator, and I'm going to give it a play now. Right, let's select our driver's name. How do we do this? Okay, right. What are we going to call him? Let's start with N. Let's put my name. N. Oh, I forgot having to put things in like this. N. How do I select? That one? No. That one? No. There we go. Okay. N. E. R. I never get if it was flashing, if that was you sort of selected it, and that would count, so that would be Nurko, if it would just not happen there. I never know these things. And then nothing for that. There you go. Space. And then space. I'm just going to put the blanks in as well. Is that working? I think that's working. Today's driver will be Nerd. Oh, come on, let's get started on this. Right, we're going from Tucson to Las Vegas in real time. It takes 8 hours. This video will be in several parts because I can't record for too long. Come on, come on, come on, bus. There we go. Right, off we go. 7:30. Okay, right, 9:30 this next video. I'll jump on the next video, because I have to break it up, because I don't have big enough SD cards to record for this long. And I do apologize, the visual quality be kind of small, but recording 8 hours of game footage is no mean feat. So we're off! Right, this is it. 360 miles left to go. the bus can only go 45 miles per hour, and as you can hear by my occasional clicking, I'll just drive over here, you can see that the bus, without me pushing anything, slowly veers to the right, so I have to constantly pay attention and go to the left. The reason I'm doing this video for the 1 millionth subscriber special and also my 500th video is because this is the worst game ever made. It was designed to be the worst game ever made. There is nothing worse than this. This is living hell. It's 8 hours. It's essentially this. Now you've seen everything this game has. There is nothing else. There's no traffic. Occasionally there might be something. Oh, there's a bit of a plant. Look, there's a plant on the right hand side. Whoa. Oh, there's two. Oh my god, I'm so excited. That's generally the limit of what's going to happen. Yeah. Right. What I've done is I've got a lot of people tweeting me crap, and I have the Steam chat trying to form a sentence. It's still trying. We'll see if anything comes out of that later. But yeah, I'm going to try and help. You guys have got to kind of help me stay sane, is the general rule about this. Oh, what's that? It's saying that it's done something exciting already. It's a sign. Is it a stop sign? I'm not going to stop. What does it say? Bus. Oh. Okay. Yeah. So, if I crash this, I fail. If I... what else can I do to fail? I think that's it. Oh, if you stop completely, you fail. So you have to just drive in a straight line, get to the end, not fail. That's the thing. Not fail is what we're going to be trying to do today. I don't recommend watching this video unless you sent me a tweet or something, because this is going to be the worst video ever. That's the thing. I kind of like the celebration of, look, I've got 500 videos and a million subscribers. Let me do the worst thing I could possibly do. I think that's quite fun. I mean, it's the worst thing I could possibly do that involves actual effort. God, I'm bored already. I'm trying to, I'm going to explain what I'm trying to do now to line it up. You see on my dashboardy bit on the right, in between the clock and the milometer, there is a thing. Christ knows what it is. It appears to be like 4 Coke cans stacked up behind each other. I'm trying to keep the desert in a diagonal line with that. The desert and the pavement, where that greater beige line goes. I'm trying to keep that lined up with that. That appears to be a good line to be on. Which means I have to constantly do that. I mean, I could go over there. Oh, fuck. Okay, so this bus speeds up when you go right a bit. Well, hang on. Oh, that, I swear they just did that. Oh, I'm just too scared because... Oh, there it is. Yeah, okay. The bus kick... Oh, crap. It's just this bit is really fast. So don't go too far over or else you skid off and crash. Okay. You may be wondering about Desert Bus. Where did it come from? Where did it go? Something, something, Cotton Eye Joe. It was never actually released. It was part of a game compilation by Penn and Teller. They were going to release a game called Smoke and Mirrors, I think it's called. Penn and Teller's Smoke and Mirrors for the Sega CD, which is what I'm currently playing this on. I'm not playing on the keyboard. This game was never released. The Smoke and Mirrors thing never got released, but one of the mini-games, because Penn and Teller do these sort of trick things, and they had lots of mini-games that were tricks for your friends, or stuff like this that was just weird and silly, so it was a compilation of that, but it never got released. And a few years ago, people dug it out and found review copies and sort of spread it around the internet, and now everybody can play it. In fact, there's actually a browser-based version I found, so you can play along. I will link that in the description. Yeah, I'm talking too fast. I've decided I've got to talk a little slower than normal. Because this is going to be a while. I kind of want to weigh down the accelerator button as well. I may attempt to do that at some point because I realise that my finger is going to go numb. If I'm trying for too long, my hand is going to really hurt after this. It's just going to be awful because it's just the same thing. It's just, nah. I'm going to get repetitive strain injury. But yeah, so this was a compilation of games. This is one of them. I haven't played the others. I do have the others, but I haven't played them. And yeah, Desert Bus. There's also Desert Bus. People would play this game for charity. Groups of people get together and play it for charity. Desert Bus for charity. I will link that in the description as well. They are fantastic people. And they do lots of laps of this, so they go back and forth. Because the point is, you drive this 360-mile journey, you get to the end, and then you get 1 point. And then you have to drive back. I won't be driving back. It takes 8 real hours. I will not be driving back. In fact, in 8 hours, that bloody pine thing that's spinning up there is going to just going to run out of smell. So yes, these people actually do this for charity, and they do loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of laps until one of them crashes it because they're tired and dying. I don't know if they do it like they do a whole lap each, or if they do like half lap each or anything, so I can't remember. I mean, I can't sit and watch it. I don't recommend you watch this video. Seriously, this is just me doing something obscure. This is the closest I will ever get to making art, I suppose. Anyway, I will talk you around what I have around me at the moment on my desk because we have nothing else to talk about. I'll get to the Twitter and the Steam chat in a minute. I have my bottle of water here, which I've left the lid on, which I'm going to clarify as mistake number one, because at some point in the near future, I'm going to have to try and maybe use my elbow in an attempt to weigh down the accelerator to open that lid. That was silly, unless I can do it one-handed. Okay, attempt to do it one-handed now. Hang on, let's try the other side of the road. Let's do a proper stunt. Oh, I think I might have it. Oh, come on. No, I can't do that. I might be able to wedge it between my knees and do it that way, because I don't have the grip. It's spinning. I also have a small handful of jelly beans to last me the 8 hours. That's all I'm going to eat for 8 hours. It's currently 4 in the morning. I've got up early to do this at 4 in the morning. Simply because then I can edit it through the rest of the day and then spend the 2 or 3 days it's going to take to upload 4 parts of this. Yeah, I got up early, but I don't know why. So I have about a handful, about 30-odd jelly beans to keep me going for this. I will explain the jelly beans as we go on. I've got to take everything so slowly. It's because normally I like to do these at 90 miles per hour. Today, I can't. I have a pen and a notepad in case I want to remember anything. Actually, that's a good point. I'll put it on the bloody pen as well. I want to write down my first stopping time will be 9:30 by that clock there. I wrote that with one hand without looking. So what I wrote was 9:03, and then the circle of O going through the 3. So I'm going to attempt to redo that now. Scribbly outy. There we go. 9:30 will be my stopping time. Lid back on the pen. God, why does this bus veer to the left? Hang on. I've got to put the lid back on with my teeth. Right. And that's generally all I have, apart from one post-it note on my computer saying, Monday, Desert Bus! And then a little small gravestone underneath that I doodled. Because I don't think I'm going to survive it. I don't know if other traffic comes from the other side. I really doubt it. So I think it'll be safer to just sort of stick to this side. But not too far this side, because we could pull over and die. Apparently I've got no fuel as well. I don't think you run out of fuel. If I do crash or fuck up in any way, that's the video end. That's where it will end, and I will cry and be a failure forever. That's how I'm going to be doing that. I've currently, what are we doing? 7 minutes so far. Oh, yes. I can't remember what the milometer was at as well, so I don't know how many miles I've done. It's about to take over. So I've done what? Is that 5 miles? Is that 14 miles? I've got to do 360 in real time. Why am I doing this? I don't know. What's that other arrow there? There's like, I see this speedometer that, because you're stuck at 45, you can't go any faster than 45. It's like no GTA. I know the fuel's empty, but what's the other one? C and H or C and N? I don't know what that is. Anybody? Anybody in the comments is still around? Hello? No? Okay. Your driver is Nerd! That's the top there. Oh, there really is. Because I kind of, when I do my videos, I'm the, like, it's essentially a double act. I run a double act of I am the comedy guy, and the straight man is played by the game, so I play off of the game. If I'm playing with someone else, I'll do the same thing. I'll be able to play off of them and stuff. But there is nothing here in this game. It's literally this. There's nothing. I mean, unless there's some sort of things that I've missed, like tiny things that happen very, very rarely, I don't think as anything else moves. I've done it all. I've spoken about everything. I've done the Coke cans. There's 3 buttons there. I wonder what they do. There's a speedometer. There's some like gum balls stored above the speedometer. There's two green and... I don't know! This is my thing. It's like I always want to do a video where I have nothing to talk about and then see how long I can talk for. And I've set myself the goal of 8 hours. Or I'll just crash now and just die. Also, I need a drink. I can feel my voice getting parched. Currently, in the Steam chat, someone is making an American flag out of emoticons. So that's useful. And the word Hitler is apparently 6 times on that screen. I did an announcement about, hey, come talk to me in the chat, and the place just exploded with spam. It's beautiful. I'm also using Twitter, where the spam is less. I'm looking now, there's still a fairly large spam. Right, here we go. This is the stunt. I'm going to get the water bottle between my legs and then open it. I'm going to actually wait till 7:40, just, you know, pad the time out a little bit. This is the dramatic opening of the bottle. I think I'll leave the lid off from now on as well. I'm sort of thinking I'm gonna leave the lid off. There we go, 7:40. Here we go. We lined up. Here we go. And it's cold because I got it out of the fridge. And it's off, lid's off, and I've been quenched. Right. And drive over that. Okay, and we'll do that again in a bit. Oh god, I just went to America. I just went to VidCon and I was on a plane for 11 hours and then I had movies to watch and I was so bored and feeling dead by the end of it. I just was like, ah. It's like, because all the movies I decided to watch were things that involved plane crashes in some way. So it's just like Iron Man 3 and Olympus Has Fallen and stuff. And I was just there going, ah, fuck. That's what I watched. There were some good films I watched. There was also some complete shit. I watched about 5 minutes of Identity Thief before realizing I'm never going to ever get American comedy. I don't like American movie comedy. Like, I've never found American movie comedy funny, but American TV comedy is superb. I don't get it. Like, you do amazing short form comedy, and your stand-up comics are amazing, but I don't like you, like The Hangover. I don't like The Hangover or 40 Year Old Virgin or any of that sort of stuff. I just don't. Anchorman, I didn't even like Anchorman. That's apparently a crime in America to not like Anchorman. I just don't get the appeal at all. I'm just like, I don't understand. And it's not really that funny. It's more, you do great character work in your TV shows, like Community, The Simpsons, Futurama, fucking anything that you guys do is, TV-wise, is funny. But the movies, I don't get, they're not funny. They're just not. They're so obvious. That's what, comedy doesn't need a budget, because the best comedy is always a dude on a stage talking into a microphone. That's just the best stand-up comedy. Or a dudette. They're fantastic female comedians. Oh, it pisses me off when you have people who are like, oh no, women can't be funny. Women can't be funny. What? That's just like eating like a Brussels sprout and going, oh, I don't like this, therefore I hate all food. It's fucking stupid. Stop saying stupid things like that, internet. Anyway, I'm now going to go to the Steam thing. Hello all, says the_fang. Hello, the_fang. There we go. The chat actually had about 1,000 people in it when I tweeted the thing. Now it only has 171. It's only been like 10 minutes, 12 minutes now. Whoops. oh god, you guys are going to abandon me before the end of this, aren't you? Now there's 18 miles on the speedometer. I'm going to write the speedometer down next time. Not the speedometer, the mileometer. I'm going to get rid of the word ometer. It's just speed, mile, and clock. Oh wait, you don't have clockometers, do you? That would be cool. To Twitter! Good luck at reading one thing on the Steam chat. Says Dolan Duck. Hi, Dolan Duck. Yes, the Steam chat's actually pretty calm now. It was a spam-filled hate, but it's okay now. Yeah. What have I talked about so far? American comedy? Fuck it, I'm gonna have a jelly bean. Shit the bed, I'm gonna have a jelly bean. You guys ready for this? Because I have one of the things I always wanted as a kid was like a vending machine, like a gumball machine sort of thing, but you have them in swimming pools in this country. I don't know why, that's just where the best sweets are. And you put 20p in and then crank the thing around. It's like really, really loud. And then you have the, you get like 2 jelly beans. That's sort of the shit you used to get out of those things and stuff. I always wanted one because they're so beautiful, these machines and stuff. So I managed to get one the other day and I filled it to the top with jelly beans and it's almost empty now. Actually, I say the other day, it was like 4 months ago now. So I don't feel that bad. But these are like the last jelly beans from the machine. So it's sort of like, well, and these are the best quality jelly beans you can get. Asda own brand. And if you don't know what Asda is, it's like Harrods. And if you don't know why, that's where the Queen shops. Asda's where the Queen shops. They're like, these are the proper quality, a pound a bag for like a million jelly beans sort of stuff. So we're going to go for, what are we going to go for? I'm going to count them first. There appears to be 35. Ooh. We're going to go for this yellow. There's a yellow one. Little yellow number here. I'm holding up to the camera that I no longer record with. Jelly Bean. So, the worst video ever. This was the plan, to make the worst video ever. Oh! It tastes like lemon fairy liquid smells. It tastes like... It's a bit... kinda lemony, but with that hint of 99% of all bacteria killed. You know what I mean? Tastes just like that. Just like that. Hang on. The clock's about to tick over to 7:45, which means we've been going for 15 minutes already! Okay, it's not. I thought it was. Man, I'm bad with time. I used to be really good with time. Sorry, I'm now eating. How rude am I? This is just the worst video ever. I'm okay with that. It's good to sort of like draw that line at the bottom and just go, nope, this is the worst video I've ever done. Anything I do from now, it can't be as worse as this. Just know you've hit that line. It's good. It's a good feeling. It's like, you know, it's like in Papers, Please. When, like, someone's fucked up something on their, hey, 15 minutes. Like, someone's fucked up something on their passport. And you're like, oh, thank fuck. Because you know you've got them at that point. Because if you don't, you have that tension in you. Of like, is it gonna, when they're walking through the after bit, when they leave your booth. And like they walk for a few steps, you're like, will the little thing come up? The scariest thing in gaming, that little printer that comes up says, you fucked up. Will that come up? But then it doesn't, or it does and stuff. So I don't like that tension, but I like to now just know that this is the worst thing I've ever done. I now have jelly beans stuck to my teeth, making it really awkward to talk, because these are really low quality jelly beans, despite the lies I just told about Asda. Which, owned by Walmart. In fact, it's essentially a Walmart, because I've been to Walmarts and they're the exact same thing. I found this out, right? We have Taco Bell in the UK. Sorry, I sound like I'm eating now. That's disgusting. I'll try not to eat anymore. We have Taco Bells in the UK. There's like three. There are three Taco Bells. There's like one in Manchester, one in Lakeside, and I can't remember what the other one is. But there's like Taco Bells that really like made me happy. I'm going to go and try one. Because I didn't try one in America. I wanted to and I totally forgot because I went to Disneyland instead. But I really want to try one. But then I found out they're in this country as well. So that's good. Oh, my CPU's heating up. Oh, I should explain. Sorry, it's really hard to chew these jelly beans because they're quite gross. I'll explain what's on my screens at the moment because, fuck it, I have time to feel. This is what like DJs feel. It's like radio DJs. This is what they feel. So on my left-hand screen, I have the Steam chat, which is calming down now. I may be able to get something out of that later. On my right-hand screen, I have the Twitter. Yeah, that's the word for it. It's 4 a.m. Shut up. On my middle screen, I have Desert Bus. On the left of Desert Bus, I have Speed Fan running, just to make sure my computer doesn't overheat and explode during this. And on the right of that, I have Bandicam and all the settings, because Bandicam's good at recording at lower sort of things. Also, it tells me that I've recorded 1.4 gigabytes so far. If I was recording this like normal, because I'm recording it at like half quality, and I'm going to boost it up. It looks a bit shit, but to be perfectly honest, I don't think you're currently sitting here just watching this footage. Like, that's why I don't really want to further stuff. I want to get that at the start. So now, this is essentially just a podcast where I'm playing a game. My finger is already in pain, my acceleration finger. That's not good. I may have to dig out some blue tack without looking away from the screen at some point. Do I have any around here? I think I do. That will be a game for later on. See, I'm just setting up all these things that we can do later on. That's good. Right, what else do we have? That's your only everything. That's really it. Yep. Right. Keep it entertaining. I'm gonna have a drink. I put the lid back on the water! What did I do that for? Oh no, I put it on loose. Okay. Oh, shit. Whoa, you drove off the road there. Like, you can drive off the road, like, for a few seconds. Excuse me. But a few seconds, like, total across all the 8 hours. So you've got to be seriously careful. You can't just screw up or anything. So I can't look away for too long. Right. Let's discuss something from Twitter. That's what we're going for now. Shit. Hang on. Wait. Oh, pro tip. Keep in the middle of the road. If the police come, you're in a bus, you'll be fine. It says, Nerdcubed pro tips. Apparently. Is that something I said? Or is that something he said to me? See, I hate when I read, like, there's a Nerdcubed out of context Tumblr that I always read. I'm like, where the fuck did I say any of this? Because, like, I process through videos so quickly now. I just don't really remember the jokes and stuff I've made. I don't think I've repeated anything yet, apart from, like, stuff that I've set up as running jokes. But it's always quite a worry that I may, you know, screw up at some point. I don't want to break my keyboard doing this. I really don't want to get another one. I really love this keyboard. I know a lot of people bitch and complain that I use a mechanical keyboard. It's a lot softer on this mic, because this is the new mic that I'm using. In fact, I'm actually going to get a different, slightly different mic, because this is slightly a bit too posh for me, so I'm going to downgrade a small amount. But yeah, a lot of people are like, oh my god, you can't hear the thing in the Gone Home video. So that's good. I'd say that. I haven't actually released the Gone Home video yet. I'm recording this Saturday. The Gone Home video is tonight. But I'm assuming that's what you're going to say. Or you won't hear it and you won't know it's gone. Suspense. Drama. Come on. Almost 20 minutes? That's like a third of the first hour, which is an eight. So that's the 24th. Oh, fuck. We're on 24th of how far we've gone. Right. Okay. Let's see if I... Let's go to the Steam chat. See if anyone's saying anything particularly useful. Right, what's the current bottom comment? Lady Narble is saying, oh god, it's gone. There we go. Meh, my scroll bar is so tiny now. Well, Lady Narble, you can get treatment for that. You can get treatment for small scroll bars nowadays. You can have your scroll bar, but you never should sort of... don't try and judge your scroll bar based on how other people see your scroll bar. Don't know what I'm saying. 20 minutes in, I've lost the plot already. 7:50! Small victories is how I'm going to survive this. I don't know. Hey! Someone's spamming the Steam chat completely. That's fantastic. I'm gonna ignore their name because fuck them. I like people that like spamming it, like, as if then I'll talk about them. No, I'm not going to give you any... I just block you inside. That's what I always do on Twitter when people are like, oh, death threat, evil comment. I'm just like, block. Don't respond. Don't do anything. Just block. It's how you stay sane. I seriously wouldn't want to be PewDiePie, because I see some of the shit that gets said about that guy. How the fuck do you put up with that? I mean, like, seriously. The amount of bile spat at a guy who just does something he likes. And I know, like, you go, oh, but his audience is shit. Yeah, well, don't send fucking, like, shit to him. It's every audience is shit, as proved by my Steam chat right now. A giant group of people will always turn to shit because the loud fucking prat bags will be the ones who make all the noise. And then everybody else will be shouting at them, and then it all goes to shit. So you just silently ignore the fucktards. That's my advice for life, really. Silently ignore the fucktards. I want that on a shirt. Right, let's go to Twitter again. No, let's not. Oh my god, Twitter's really slowing down. Everybody's gonna abandon me before the 8 hours. Oh, that's a good question. Mr. Zombie Zealot has asked, have you actually been working out since you did that video of you exercising with the Kinect? No. A lot of people, exercise makes them happy. You know what makes me happy? Food. Specifically, lots of food. I am a fat fuck, I will admit that. I have nothing... I don't like exercising. Like, I like exercising if it's, like, doing shit. I don't like exercising, like, as the main shit. It's like I don't like roast dinners, because it's just like you don't do anything with the food. It's like, here's meat and vegetables, fucking eat that shit. I like actually putting in some, like, effort and having there to be something in it. Like, I'll go for, like, a jog. If I didn't live in London, I'd be shot if I tried to go to jog in East London. So fuck that. But I'll go for a walk. I'll go for a walk down the Thames. That'd be lovely. That's great fun. And I'll climb the 27 flights of stairs to my apartment in 3 goes, you know, just because that's a little bit of exercise. But just standing around going, oh, exercise these muscles you didn't even know you have. Well, if I didn't know I had them, I'm not going to use them now. I'm like, I'm getting to that point. Like, isn't it 26? Is the year, like, when you're about 26 years old, that's where the decline sets in and you're currently getting better. So I'm 24 now. My plan is to be like 25, just get like really fit for the last 6 months, and as soon as I turn 26, just sort of coast. That's my plan. I don't want to be some sort of muscle bound oiled god thing. I don't like that sort of I like me. I think I'm gorgeous. I know I'm gorgeous. Fuck you all. It's just, and I just the only thing I don't want is for like my heart to implode. Like, that's something I don't particularly want. And that's sort of, for the amount of cheese I consume, the scientists would refer to that as, like, an inevitability or something. But, well, I'll fight it. I'm gonna fight the heart cheesy explosion. Oh, that sounds delicious. One of my favorite recipes is hearts. Like, I'm the opposite of a vegetarian. Like, because I believe that if you're gonna eat an animal, you've gotta fucking wanna eat all the animal. Like, don't let anything go to waste. Just like eat it, but use it all. Like if you're just gonna kill a cow and like chop like one bit off and chuck the rest away, fuck that shit. I mean, give me the fucking intestines. Give me the brain, give me the heart. Hearts are the nicest thing. Because they're like one of the most used muscles, so they are just gorgeous. Ugh. I need to get some hearts in. Like, because when I do hearts, you get, like, you chop all the gooey bits in the middle out, and then you save those for gravy for later. And then you sort of, just roast them in the oven. Get some, like, sage and onion stuffing in there and roast them. Oh, my God. God, I'm going to do that tonight. Like, seriously, that's it. I'm just like, eat and use all the animal, or just fuck off. It's like the people who get, like, the animal for, like, one thing. I'm like, what the fuck's the point of that? Although, what's the thing they got there? They got that sort of, like, synthesized meat stuff. They have that synthesized meat that is, if you didn't hear about this, they grew meat in a lab from, like, stem cells. And it costs, like, stupid amounts of money to do it. But, like, they did it a few years ago, and it costs, like, 8 times the amount. So it's getting cheaper and cheaper to do it constantly. And they made it, like, into a hamburger and stuff, and then got, like, food experts to eat it. And they were like, yeah, this tastes like meat. Which is great. I mean, seriously. But the thing I have there is, like, where do vegans stand on that? Like, if you, like, can take the stem cells without hurting the animal, just put it for a tiny inconvenience for a little bit. And it was something like a handful of cells... handful of smells? Sorry, I do apologize. A handful of cells can make, like... what was it? Was it 10 tons? 10 tons of meat from, like, a tiny little one syringe of cells. That's just fucking... That's just amazing. Like, that's the future right there. That's where we should fund shit. Because I know there's, like, some people are like, oh, no, we need to let technology out of food. And they're people that are skinny and have weird hair and are going to die. Because organic food is just... I don't get this organic food thing at all. Because, like, people have, like... They'll say, oh, you have to eat this food because it was... This tomato was happy and it grew on a farm and it was had friends with other tomatoes and they had a tomato social club. And what's the point? Like, it doesn't taste any difference from these, like, other tomatoes. In fact, these other tomatoes that are genetically modified with the best and tastiest ones, they're the better ones. If you can, like, modify food to make it better, I fucking know. People are stupid. But it's like, the thing I already heard is, like, organic food is cooked, like, with... It's grown. My God, my tongue has failed me already. It's grown with organic fertilizers, which is shit, literally. So, why would you want that? I mean, like, non-organic food is grown with fertilizers that are chemically made by scientists to be safe. And they don't have loads of diseases, and they didn't come from a cow's ass. I mean, that's better. Surely, that's better. To have sort of, you know, science stuff. I just trust science with my life. I have to. I live miles up in the air. But I don't know. I don't get it. This push against GM food, like, countries are outlawing it and stuff. It's just, I mean, the only reason I could say that is if we're getting, like, huge money from, like, say, the meat industry or something. But I don't know anything anymore. I'm going to try and get a drink. That's all I'm going to do. I need a drink because I'm a little parched. This is now... We've nearly been recording for half an hour, which is probably one of my longest ever unedited videos. I do have to pause for breath and to... I'm just fat. Fuck it. I'm hot and sweaty and I hate everything right now. My computer's cooling down, so that's it. One of the reasons I'm recording this at 4 a.m. is so... By the time I finish, it should be sort of noon, if I've done my maths right. No, that's 8 hours, so it should be sort of noon, so then the heat of the day starts. I don't want to be trapped in a sealed room with fucking computer at stupid degrees, because it's just so fucking warm. And I can't turn my air conditioner on, because it's far too noisy. So that's why I'm recording it early. That's what someone said. What was the original question? I just branched off there. Someone said something about something. Mr. Zombie Zealot said something, and I don't remember what it was. But it made me talk about GM food and synthesized meat. And hang on, let's see if I can track back the entire conversation. I love tracking back conversations to see how you got there. It's fantastic. Synthesized meat came from cows, eating cows, food, some... It's really like, have you played Assassin's Creed? And then I got from that. I can't remember at all. I seriously want to try that synthesized meat. Like, that's like sort of just... That's the thing. That's where we should be putting all our money. Because, like, everybody's starving. Like, we don't have enough... If we did everything organically, we wouldn't have enough food. We don't have enough land to grow enough food for everyone. We just don't at all. So if we do GM stuff, we can get stuff that grows closer together and better and... why aren't we doing that? Why are people against it? Do you know who's against it? It's fucking these skinny hippie bastards. And they look like skinny hippie bastards who think the government is poisoning all their food and shit. And... I don't know. I'm not against all hippies and shit. I know the comments are already started saying that. But it's like just... Just fuck off. As Penn Jillette said, who made this fucking game? If you and yours aren't starving, you need to shut the fuck up. And I agree with that in pretty much everything. That's why I try and not have opinions on anything. He lied. I try and have an opinion on anything. Oh, we're coming up to half past. I'm going to have another fucking jelly bean at half past. Fuck. Don't drive off. We still going 45? Yeah, I don't think I've gone off yet. There's been no other sound effect. I'm wearing my headphones to listen to the sound and realizing that it's slowly driving me insane because it's essentially white noise. Come on, half past. We can do it. We can do it. Half past. We can do it. I've been told this is about 8 hours. Okay? So I've been told this is about 8 hours long. I don't know anything more than that it's about 8 hours. So, yeah. That's all I know. It could be more than 8 hours. It's about 8 hours. I don't know if it's less or more. I don't know when to end the last video, basically, because I can record for about 2.5 hours on this without it cutting out, so I decided to do it in 4 parts of 2, because that gives me leeway and stuff in case it's a bit loud or whatever. But, yeah. It's going to be fun. Come on, tick over to 8 o'clock. Yay! Half an hour done. Oh, my back hurts. 16th of the way there. I'm going to have a jelly bean now. What colour shall I go for? I did a yellow, so let's... I'm going to go for a green this time. It is a sort of... It looks a bit grape green, is what I'm thinking. So, let's have a taste of this jelly bean. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, fuck. Thing, when I bought these jelly beans, some of them were sour. Don't get me because of a jelly bean. Some of them were sour jelly beans, so they're a little painful to eat. Yeah, that's what flavor is that? Apple, I think. Tastes more like acid than anything. Just like it's just hydrochloric acid. That's what flavor it is. Oh, it's pear! It's pear, that's what it is. I got that little softness of pear. It's sour pear. Interesting. Okay, give me a minute to work this out. That's fine. I'm now going to eat this a bit quicker, because last time I didn't, and I sounded gross for ages. Now, I'm going to read more questions while I do this. Don't mind me. Right. Yeah, people are having their own conversations in the Steam chat. It's essentially worthless right now, but it's funny. Who do you think is on Dan's desert bus? Says real fear. Nobody. According to that mirror up there, there's nobody on my bus. I'm all alone. I've decided already. I'm not gonna watch this video back because normally I watch everything back just to make sure it's good enough. Because like, if a video isn't good enough, I don't upload it. But like, I've decided on this. I'm like, fuck it. This is going up. And that's fucking it. That's the line I've drawn here. Is this video is going up, and that's it. My hand is really starting to hurt. Oh, and I'm getting all hot. It's so horrible in here. Actually, my computer is cooling down, though. Yay for water cooling. When it doesn't explode and kill you. Oh, God. That was such fun with my computer. Like, my last computer just, like, burst at Christmas time. And, like, just everybody was like, oh, that's what you get for buying a pre-built. I'm like, okay. First, it wasn't pre-built. I had it made to my specifications. And two, I got an entirely new computer, like not a single part of it was done, for no money, when it fucked up. If I had built that myself and it fucked up, I would have had to buy mostly of the parts again. Most of the parts, it would have been human error that I didn't do something right. So, the reason I got it done like that was so I'd have a warranty on it for 3 years. That is the reason I did it. I know it's more expensive, but when shit like that happens, it would have been way more expensive to do the other way, because I would have had to build the fucking thing twice. But yeah, I do like SoPal. This machine is fantastic. I mean, seriously. Like, it's just... I kind of was considering the other day to put 3 Titans in it instead of the 3 680s it's got. But, like, at the moment, I'm playing... I was jumping in and out of Battlefield 3. And I can play that across 3 screens at 120 frames a second. I'm just like, I don't fucking need anything else right now. It's sort of... The next gen might have to push me up, but it's seriously... It's so good to have that, because I've always been, like... hand-me-down machines like my entire life, and it's so nice to finally have that one. And it just makes editing so much easier, so you guys massively benefit from me having a good computer. I keep pushing this button really hard. I kind of want to let go of the accelerator for 5 seconds. Ow. Okay, re-accelerate. If you stop, it counts as a crash. That's something I learned, so don't stop. Never give up. Hold your head high and get to the bus stop, as the Spice Girls once said. I've recorded 2.5 gigabytes of data right now, which is about what I would record in about 15 seconds of normal video. Like, normal 1080p video is about 2.5 gigs on Fraps. Fraps is huge. I should use Bandicam. Although Bandicam's sound is awful. That's why I kind of stick with Fraps, because it's got like a much nicer sound. I don't know. Let's have some... let's go to Twitter. Ooh, thoughts on GTA 5 Online trailer from Slayer 7691. It looks fucking mental. Like, I don't really like online very much. I always said that I don't really like online very much, but it's sort of, I kind of like online, but I get bored after a while because it's just doing the same thing over and over again. The only time I don't really get bored and doing the same thing over and over again is when I can, like, sort of do my own stuff. It's like in Battlefield 3, you've got to fucking win. You've got a game and you've got to win stuff. But if it's something open world, like Minecraft, I can play Minecraft all fucking day, even though it is sort of the same thing. You're just constantly doing new stuff with it. So, excuse me, I burped. GTA getting an online mode is essentially just GTA. Maybe the first multiplayer game I play a lot of. Like, a hell of a lot of. Like, I am really starting to worry about the videos that I'm going to be doing, because I'm taking a week off when GTA comes out. Like, I will have a week's videos ready and stuff, but I won't be doing a GTA video straight away, because I'm going to just sit and savor it. So, because I never do that. I never, ever, ever record a video when I'm playing a game first time, if it's a game I want to play. If it's just something I've just found and picked up, I'll do a video. But if it's something I want to play, I don't, because I've got a... The thing that screws over a lot of people who make YouTube videos is they don't separate work and play. Fucking hell, I need to lock my bottle over. I'm going to put the lid back on. Excuse me. They don't separate work from play, and it just screws them over in the end, because you can't separate your job from your hobby. So I've made a conscious effort to never play a game first time that I was really excited for. So if I really want to play something, I'll buy a copy of it, play it, and then I'll do a video on it when I'm done with it. That's how I roll. And that's I recommend that as a tip to getting started on YouTube. Try it. Just remember to don't record and upload and stream everything, because it'll turn gaming into a job, and I'm so against turning this into a job. Like, I now I've got a new camera, so I've been recording with like a fucking the equivalent of like a flip camera, just sitting in my face. I've been essentially recording a face cam every single time, just not uploading the face cam. That's what I've been doing. What the fuck was I saying? It's just gone. Oh, I'm such a fucking old man now. It's like yesterday, I went to buy conditioner, because fuck you, I condition my hair. I like to look swanky. I always buy shampoo and conditioner. I always have stuff. But I always run out of conditioner first. I don't know why, it comes in smaller bottles and some shit, and it always looks different. So I went to fucking Waitrose, because I go to Waitrose, because I like solid food and stuff. I go to Asda for, like, the plain stuff, like pasta and stuff, but, like, for my meats and things, I go to Waitrose. I'm a posh fuck, it doesn't matter. I grew up working class, and now I can just about afford Waitrose, so I'm going to go to fucking Waitrose to get my nice meats. So I go to buy some conditioner, because I'm out of conditioner. And they had a special offer on shampoo. Special offer on shampoo. Two of my favourite shampoos is this apple-smelling Head & Shoulders. It's fucking delicious. I smell, like, amazing. I'm coming across as kind of gay here. That's sort of... I do that. Fuck it, I don't care. I'm very comfortable with who I am. I'm straight, I know it, and I want to look fabulous. Fuck you all. So I got these two bottles of shampoo and stuff, and then I was like, conditioner. And then there was like a separate bit that has conditioner and all the conditioners and stuff. So I was looking through them all, and there was fucking loads of different types and stuff, and I was like, let's go for one. They've all got fucking like sleek and shiny hair, fucking this sort of hair. I don't give that much of a shit, to be perfect. I just want sort of like normal. They didn't have normal, and I decided that the most normal was sleek and shiny, because that's sort of... Oh no, it was sort of like thick, because I got quite thick hair, is what I've been told by hairdressers after where you're going on holiday. So I bought this shampoo, the two shampoos and a conditioner. And I got home, and I was having a shower this morning, just getting ready for doing this and stuff, and I got the new conditioner out, and it was fucking shampoo! And I looked at the label, it just blatantly says shampoo on it. I was like, it's just the most old man moment I've ever had, of just buying something that's got the fucking... It's so obviously labelled that way, and I completely fucked up. It's just, I'm there going, how did I do that? Like, it says blatantly on their shampoo. And I don't know how... I don't fucking know how I did that. But now I have three bottles of shampoo and I need conditioner. So... Fuck it, I don't care. So yeah, back into the GTA 5 trailer. Oh god. I'll do that. I'll take tangents and I may never go back. What was it? Oh no, GTA 5 online trailer. Yeah. Like, my favourite thing about games is sort of like... Immersion is like the thing that really sells me over. So, like, I really, really love the fact you can buy your houses and stuff and then go to your houses and just sort of virtually sit and enjoy a virtual view in a virtual house. That's sort of that. That's what I like. That's why I really like Minecraft and things. But, like, having that as a persistent online thing with all those really awesome features they listed and stuff, like the garages and stuff, getting insurance and that sort of thing, it's sort of like Home or Second Life, but with GTA's gameplay. That sounds delicious. That really sounds delicious. I'm really seriously stoked. I'm really seriously stoked for GTA 5. I mean, since Saints Row 4 has gone a bit too boring for me. I know that's the wrong word. It's the fucking wrong word. I've got sort of this issue with Deep Silver, the guys who make Saints Row, because they released Ride to Hell, which was the worst game. To be perfectly honest, I'm enjoying this way more than Ride to Hell Retribution. Ride to Hell was awful. So I'm sort of pissed off at Deep Silver. They did that torso thing for Dead Island. They had that naked woman torso you could put, not naked, she had a bikini on, but like half zombified. It was just a torso, so it didn't have an head and arms or body. It was just the torso, just basically a pair of plastic tits you could buy to stick in your room, and that kind of just made me feel quite uncomfortable. And then they did a whole, oh, actually, we're not going to release this, we made a mistake. And I was like, okay, no, fine, that could have been some sort of stunt bollocks. But then they fucking did release it, and I just, people got like copies of it, and I was like, what the fuck? I mean, and who the fuck buys that sort of shit? I don't fucking know. But yeah, so that was, they pissed me off with that. They pissed me off with Ride to Hell, so I sort of didn't really want to cover Saints Row. But also, like, Saints Row was best in Saints Row 2. And I keep getting called a hipster for this. People call me hipsters for these things. I don't fucking know why. Saints Row 2 was the best because Saints Row 2 had sort of, like, more levels of crazy than Grand Theft Auto, but was still in a realistic world. So the contrast of the shit you were doing to the world you were in was greater. So when Saints Row 3 came along and was like sort of like a crazy world doing crazy shit, it felt like the crazy shit was normal and standard. Like, if the world accepts like the Genki Bowl games and stuff and you driving around in a giant yarn thing as normal, then your other, it just doesn't seem crazy anymore. So sort of like that, because that's what's really great about GTA, is it's a rebellion against the system. That's why we all love GTA so much. You're really pushing against that system of these are the rules and this is all that sort of shit, and you're fighting it, and Saints Row let you fight it in a really silly way, but now it's all like aliens and shit. It just seems so standard. I know that's the weirdest thing, but that's just sort of how I roll, really. That's why I'm looking forward to GTA 5, because GTA 4 was fucking humorless. Like, it had jokes and stuff, but it was just humorless. I didn't like Nico. I mean, I didn't like Nico's story either. And it was that huge, I don't know what the narrative break, whatever. Crack. Narrative crack sounds fantastic. And the narrative didn't fit the gameplay. So you've got Nico who's constantly going, oh, woe is me, immigrant woes. Oh, do I want to kill this person who betrayed me? Do I not? Oh. And then you've got, like, the four-leaf clover mission where you fucking go and gun down loads of innocent police officers and rob a bank. And it's just, I don't know, I never liked Nico for that, because he had, like, two different things. There was the cutscene Nico, and then there was the gameplay Nico. So GTA 5 is really embracing that, like, especially with Trevor. Like, you want to be a fuckhead? Fine, we'll just make you a fuckhead. And even if that sucks, you've got GTA Online, which will let you be a fuckhead, but online. And also offline. In fact, there's a passive mode. You can play it with non-violent. Apparently you can make, like, your thing and go, I'm non-violent, so no one can shoot stuff, and you can't shoot stuff. So you could just live in that world. That may be really exciting. I mean, you could literally play Grand Theft Auto without violence. Like, you could get, like, say you do, like, the early mission or whatever, and then you, like, with that little bit of money, you invest it in the stock market, and that you sort of try and make money on and things. And if that goes wrong, then you have to turn to crime and stuff. And that's a great narrative. And that's your narrative. You build this narrative as you go. I mean, you could literally have it so you just invite your friends around for tennis every now and then and just play the stocks and become a proper banker. I mean, that the level of roleplay that GTA 5 offers is, it's just the potential there is really exciting. I think it's going to be a real landmark game, GTA 5. I mean, because it's got, GTA 4 kind of failed, in my opinion, because it didn't have the stuff to do. I mean, I love GTA 4 now, because the modding community made it something very special. Something insane. Excuse me for a second, I need to cough my lungs out. But I lied, I didn't cough my lung out. But yeah, so it sort of, before the mods and stuff came out, it was a very serious, dull game with not much to do, really, for a GTA, especially coming off of the incredible San Andreas, which is the best game ever made. It's not in my top 5 favourite games, but there is no real denying that San Andreas, if you look at the history of gaming, is like one of the most, the greatest landmarks in gaming ever. I mean, it's up there with like Minecraft. Minecraft really pushed indie gaming and pushed like Let's Players, and Minecraft spawned so many amazing things. And I think San Andreas really, if San Andreas was like a fantastic merger of RPG and like non-RPG gameplay, it was the biggest landscape ever. It was so much freedom and stuff to do, and an actual solid story with it, and real genuine characters plus humor. It was a complete landmark game, the best game of last generation by a huge, huge way. Again, not my favorite game, because my favorite game was Shadow of the Colossus, but for stuff Shadow of the Colossus did, I don't think it's as landmark and history making as San Andreas was. So I'm losing my train of thought, really, here. I'm going across in tangents. But San Andreas was just... I went back recently to play it on PC, and it has, like, 3D support. And so I'm playing it in 3D across three screens, and it's just such a different game. And I've installed, like, some slightly higher texture mods and things and stuff, and it just feels superb. But I think, you know, I think that GTA 5 is going to be that game again. Maybe not GTA 5, I think maybe GTA Online will do that sort of huge push. I mean, because the jump from Vice City to San Andreas is just remarkable. It's the same as the jump between GTA 2 and GTA 3. And I'm not a huge GTA 3 fan, but that's only because I played it after San Andreas. I didn't actually play that until quite later on. I still 100%ed it. I've 100%ed every single GTA game except 4. Only one I haven't done. I need a quick drink. Excuse me. Ah. Got a tingle at the back of my throat. So yeah, I haven't 100%ed 4. In fact, I didn't even finish the story on 4. That's the downside of GTA 4. It's the only one I never did. I think that may be more of like where I was. Like, because when you're small and at school, you want games that last. Like, and as I've got older, I like shorter games. I don't really like investing a lot of time and stuff into games unless it's something like superb or like a bit more randomized, like FTL or something. So I maybe 100% of them all because I could only really afford a game a year, and so I would buy the GTA that came out that year. Thank God my parents let me have that. In fact, it was my uncle who lent me GTA Vice City, and it was just one of the most remarkable experiences ever, just playing GTA Vice City when I was quite young and shouldn't have done. Just superb when I was at school. Oh, the best thing about school was, leaving school. But I hate people! I hate people who say that the school days are the best days of your life. These are people who were fucking cheerleaders or some shit because they'll never get it better. But it's just, school is shit. School is the worst because you have so much fucking pressure and no freedom. Like, as an adult, you have, you have, like, fucking pressure. But you can just go, fuck it, I'm gonna take drugs and drive. You don't get that as a kid. You just sort of like, fuck it, I'm gonna go to my room and read. I'm gonna go hang out with my friends. Your parents go, you can't hang out with your friends. I mean, I grew up without the internet as a child, so it was like fucking, I had to borrow the phone, and I couldn't phone people, like, you can't really, like, afford phone calls for too long, so I could sort of half call or make them call me sort of thing, and so I didn't really have any friends. Aww. But no, fucking, school is the worst. If you're in school right now, and you're not enjoying it, that's perfectly reasonable, because it is a pile of wank. It's just awful, and everything gets so much better when you get out of school, like, seriously. Just fucking, it's superb. I just, seriously, if you're in school right now and you can't wait to get out of school, just be aware, it's fucking amazing. And ignore the people who say that this is the best time of your life, because they're fucking liars or really boring people. And I'm actually technically a liar, but I don't know. That's a rant about school that came off of, what do you think about the GTA 5 online trailer? I'm going to have another drink. I'm kind of worried I may run out of drink. I'm more worried that I may need to pee at some point. I haven't quite thought of that. Maybe I'll be able to quickly go in my 2-hour breaks. I'll have to weigh down the accelerator or something. I'll go from here. I'll move my entire desk to the bathroom. That would be a great idea. Why did I not try that? Okay, how long have we been going for? Whack, 45 minutes already. Okay, nearly an eighth of the way there. Ah, it's going so quickly. It's not. I know how percentages work, but whatever. Right, let's get a question from, what do I want to go? Let's in the Steam chat. The Steam chat is just someone going, USA! USA! Okie dokie, let's go to Twitter. Right, where are we? What are we? Ah, there we go. That's a great question from Z. Just Z. I realise these names aren't the at names, so this is just people's names, but this person has referred to themselves as Z with the egg picture. Which was overall better, PS2 or PS3? PS2. Which is a really awful thing to say because we're really excited for a PS3 game, but PS2 was that wonderful era. It was between sort of, how do I best put this? Budget and innovation were nice at that point. Budgets for games to look like top range games now are too high. That's the thing. Games are too cheap and the budgets are too high because of next generation graphics and things, which is why I'm not really particularly excited about the next gen consoles. So with the PS2, you have... I like Akami. I don't think Akami would have been made in this generation. I mean, they re-release it now because it was a success, but what else did they sort of have? Like, because I really think that the PS2 era was the best era in gaming. I mean, I lie. It was the best era in console gaming because I think at the moment indie gaming has never been better, and indie gaming is where gaming is currently at, because when you get huge budgets, you lose ideas. Because you have to go with publishers. Publishers say, no, we want these things and these things and these things and these things. So you really sort of lose out on ideas. Occasionally, the publisher is awesome and you get amazing things. Like, Ubisoft tend to do good stuff. Like Far Cry 3, for instance. Far Cry Blood Dragon. Who the fuck would let Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon through? Like, I don't see that game being made by any other really big people. So Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon is amazing. Rayman Legends, I'm so looking forward to. So I really, really like Ubisoft. And what Ubisoft do. So they've sort of got that. But then again, Rayman's quite low budget. Far Cry Blood Dragon was low budget. So it's sort of, when budgets are lower, ideas are better, which is like indie games, you have things like Minecraft, FTL, and that sort of thing that would never get made with big budgets. So that's where the ideas are. So I kind of like smaller budget games. Then again, my game I'm most looking forward to now is GTA 5, which is one of the biggest budget games ever. But the trust that the Rockstar team have with their publishers mean that they can just make whatever the fuck they want. So that's the sort of stage you need to get to, and there are so few people that are actually at that stage now. It's really... I don't know. It's kind of... there's always that nostalgia thing about which is better, PS2 or PS3. But then again, I grew up really with a PS1. If I didn't grow up with a PS1, I grew up with a Sega Mega Drive. I couldn't afford a PS1. So sort of... That's why I think Sonic is better than Mario. Obviously, the games are much more fun. You're all blind. Seriously, better graphics, better gameplay, and... not as difficult, which is great when you're a child. I could never finish Mario. In fact, I only finished Mario the other year. I actually bothered to sit down and finish the original Mario, and it's really fucking hard. It's incredibly well designed, but it's sort of... I kind of like the speed of Sonic and the variety and stuff. Mario is a bit samey and things. Anyway. I would go PS2, because... It's weird, you don't really get those little indie titles on PS3 at all. It looks like they're going to try with it at the PS4, which is why... That's sort of the thing that's really kind of slightly exciting about the PS4, is I think they may try and get those exciting indie titles. I mean, I think people are now looking out for the next Minecraft or the next that sort of thing, so they're going to slightly put money in places. So I think it's an exciting time for gaming, but I think the PS3 was just... I mean, like, because I sold all my PS3 games. Like, all the ones I didn't play. So I was left with 3, and that was Just Cause 2, Little Big Planet 2, and Red Dead Redemption. They were the 3 that I couldn't get rid of. I wanted to stay. So, and then I got rid of my PS2 games as well. I sold a lot of my PS2 games, and I've got, like, a stack of about 40 games left. Things like Devil May Cry, the GTAs, Metal Gear Solid. There's just so much great stuff in that era. But there's stuff like, because I keep buying new games that I didn't try for the PS2, like Black and stuff like that, that I was really excited about and always wanted to play, and then played it. I was like, holy crap, some of this is amazing. Some of it was a bit shitty and as worn out. Like, I didn't really like Half-Life 2, and I know that's sort of, that's a criminal sin as a PC gamer, but I didn't like Half-Life 2 when I played it. I was just there going, yeah, I've seen this done a million times, and I know this was like the first time it was done, but I have no nostalgia for this. But when I played Black, which I played, like, I think it was after Half-Life 2, it may have been just a bit before, it's very close to that, I was blown away by it, because it was still a really solid game, and I enjoyed playing it, and I played it straight through, whereas I didn't with Half-Life 2, which is why when people are like, oh my god, Half-Life 3, I'm like, eh, I'm more excited about Left 4 Dead 3, to be honest. That's sort of where my allegiances lie. Not Portal 3, fuck no, not Portal 3. Unless they give us back some of the Portal 1 goodness. Never a big fan of Portal 2. I know people hate me for that comment, but seriously, Portal 1 was a unique, weird, little, small budget indie game thing. They gave it a budget and it fucking ruined it. Well, gameplay-wise, I mean, the humour was better. The humour was better, the atmosphere was gone, because the you never knew what the fuck GLaDOS was going to do. I mean, now when you knew GLaDOS, she became sort of a laughingstock sort of character. so you didn't really know what was going to be going on there. But yeah, I wasn't. And I mean, the puzzles just weren't really there. I mean, they would introduce a puzzle mechanic and then give you like one small test on it, and then they would introduce another puzzle mechanic, and they had too much going on with too big of a budget, and it wasn't really, wasn't as good as Portal 1, in my opinion, which I do consider to be one of the two perfect games. I have these games that are perfect. Portal 1 is perfect. It's flawless. There are no errors with Portal. It is, everything about it is spot on, perfect and pristine. I wouldn't change a thing. Because I even my favourite games, I would change stuff. Like Just Cause 2, I've got reams of shit I would change about it. I wouldn't change a hair on Portal's head. And the other one is Shadow of the Colossus. I think Shadow of the Colossus is perfect. I don't think they'll be changed. Even San Andreas. I mean, I would change some stuff about San Andreas. I still think it's a landmark game. I still think it's superb. This is actually quite good. I've been discussing quite a lot more than I thought I would. I'm going to have another quick drink. Please excuse me. Ah, right. Let's have a gander at the chat. Yeah, this is quite... what else was I going to say? There was something else I was going to say about Samir and stuff. Like, I mean, the PS3 was an exciting era because games sort of went HD and stuff, and we did get sort of those big sort of... Did we? I mean, nothing was really... What was game-changing in the PS3 era? Like, the PS2 era and that sort of whole thing there had some serious stuff in it. Like, things that just changed... I mean, GTA 3 being the big, huge, holy fucking hell's bells one. I mean, that came out, like, a few days after September 11th, 9/11. So... I mean, because that's why the dodo doesn't have wings. They clipped it. They took out children. There was going to be children you could run over and maim. There was a school. There was so much stuff. If you ever read the change notes for GTA 3 just before its release, because of 9/11, you will be astounded that game ever came out. It was just, the amount of stuff they cut is insane and terrifying. And I can't imagine where GTA would be now if they hadn't cut it all. It's a really weird thing to think about. You sort of got all those landmark games and things that really changed everything, but really, did the PlayStation 3 do much? I mean, I don't know. I'm trying to think now. Red Dead Redemption wasn't revolutionary. It was just an amazing game. The soundtrack, the visuals, everything. Just really, especially after GTA 5. I mean, because Red Dead Redemption had that sort of same sort of styling as GTA 4, really, where it was a bit more serious than the usual GTA fare. But it wasn't, sort of dark. It was still light and still enjoyable, even after the ending and stuff. It was still very solid. What else was there? Little Big Planet. I mean, online gaming, I suppose, would be the big change. But that really wasn't a very particular game thing. And to be perfectly honest, from the PC was doing it back then. In fact, fuck that. I used to play Time Splitters Future Perfect online with my PS2 because I have the network adapter. I actually would play games online on my PS2. I played tons of that. That was amazing. Those cheated bastards who played as Monkey. I used to play as Future Cortez because I was an idiot. So yeah, what else have I really done? I mean, shit, the only things I can think about that really came from the PS3 era was fucking DLC. And add-ons. I mean, DLC replaced expansion packs, and expansion packs were the shit. Expansion packs are amazing. I mean, they completely change games to just... the nth degree. They're amazing. I love expansion packs. Because Rockstar did expansion packs. Rockstar still do expansion packs. I mean, I'm really looking forward to what GTA 5 does, because look, we had GTA 4 had the episodes from Liberty City. They were two expansion packs. In fact, in my honest opinion, Ballad of Gay Tony is one of the best Grand Theft Autos, because they brought back that humor, they brought back sort of more extreme stuff, had like parachuting, the explosive shotgun that I love. So whenever you see me playing GTA, it's always Ballad of Gay Tony, because that is the one that I absolutely adore. It had the sort of silly characters and things. Omid Jalili, one of my favourite comedians, was in it, playing an absolutely superb character. So that was expansion pack. Red Dead Redemption had Undead Nightmare, which, one of the best expansion packs I've ever played, completely changed the game. Completely, for such a cheap price. But then you get shit like just DLC and stuff. So the best DLC of this era is just expansion packs. So DLC wasn't something I liked. Microtransactions and free-to-play sort of came from the PS3 era. Well, not really the PS3, that was more a PC thing. But free-to-play, I fucking hate free. It's like Candy Crush. I had a little tweet rant about this the other day. I literally, while I was tweeting this, I installed Candy Crush and played it for a while. And it's Bejeweled. How the fuck are people spending £300 on this and $300 stuff? It's just, free-to-play plays on people's addictions, and I don't like it. I really don't like free-to-play at all. It's the worst thing about gaming right now. Because it's not. I mean, you look at the top grossing games on the Google Play Store or iOS and stuff, and they're all free-to-play games. All of them. But you're like, how are these making money if they're free-to-play? Because it's not free-to-play. It's free-to-pay more than anything. You're free-to-pay for this shit. And you pay more money than you would if you just bought the game outright. Which is just... I don't know, I've just noticed... Ooh, excuse me, the time. Look at that. I've been doing this for an hour. Oh god, I'm tired. Right. 1/8 of the way left. Let's stop talking about the eras and stuff. I think. I'm just trying to think now, what else really changed in the PS3 era? I mean, most of it was negative, really. I think we may be in for a better era this time. Because all this shit's already in place, it's not going to get really worse, is it? Famous last words. Okay, it may get worse, but I think they're going to try and push indies and things. And they can't really change indies. I mean, they may get specific companies and make them un-indie, whatever the fuck that is, the difference between indie or whatever. But I don't think they're going to be able to completely fuck over a dude who wants to make a video game. I don't think that's going to change. And the stuff like Steam Greenlight, although not perfect, is changing a lot. So I think there's going to be some good shit coming soon. I'm hopeful for the future. That's what I'm going to say. Right. Let's have a look at the questions. Nathan Evans asks, how's your hand holding up thus far? It is fucking killing me. My left hand is fine. The one that's holding it down is really killing me. I may attempt to get some blue tack. I think I should have some just round the corner there. On my I have a very large desk, so let's have a... my desk has an expansion pack. I've got this desk that fits two of my screens because I like three screens for editing. Which, if you ever want to be an editor, quick tip, get at least two screens. You can't edit on one screen. It is hell. It is hell on earth. Get a good computer and three screens. Even cheap screens. It doesn't really matter. I mean, computer screens are so fucking cheap these days. It's untrue. Like, for the price of a game, you can get a screen that worked pretty fucking well at 1080p. Not great, not superb, not great contrast, not 3D, not, like, fucking shit, but fucking it will work well enough. So I've got, like, this expansion, like, just like a dot of wood that my dad made. Like a separate table to house my third screen and the computer, because I want it head height. So there's some... it's a different colour and everything. It literally is just bolted on. But I absolutely love that. It's fantastic. Right, I'm going to attempt to slide over here. I apologise. Oh, come on. I'm now blindly reaching around the corner of my desk. Oh! I have a drawer. Not a drawer. A tin that I think I've got some blue tack in. I'm going to try and cheat. Fuck! Alright, I don't have blue tack in there. That's where I thought I had my blue tack. Okay. Get out of the way. Oh, there's my Euro adapter. I was looking for that. Cool. Oh, shit. I'm rubbish. Wait! Just noticed we've gone past 8:30. We've been doing this now for 1 hour! 1 hour in. And I can smell... I can smell, like, train... You know train... The brake smell of trains? Like, what train stations smell like? That's what I can smell right now. That's really weird and creeping me out slightly. Is anything... Hang on. Oh, my computer sounds normal. That's weird. It's running at normal temps and stuff. It's running at 57 degrees C is the CPU, which is where it normally idles at. Graphics cards idling at 40 degrees C, which is nice. I do love water cooling. God, I love water cooling so much. I recommend it to everyone. My top computer, because I've got my second computer running. Oh, no, it's not running. Oh, that was a wise decision. What are we going to do? Another jelly bean? Okie dokie. Right, this is the blue one. It's blue. It's just like a light, a baby blue colour. Let's see what it is. Ha 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 ha. I've eaten a lot of these and I don't like them yet. It tastes like... You know when you fall over onto like grass but your mouth's open a bit? So you get like grass in your mouth? That. That's the best way I can describe that taste. Like, you know, like I'm talking like autumny time when the grass is a bit flaky. You know, that's what this tastes like. With the texture of, worms. Yeah. Texture of worms is how... Oh, yeah, that's disgusting. So gross. Anyway, let's get a question from Steam. There's absolutely nothing. They're all just shouting at each other. It's wonderful. Like, Steam is people talking to each other, and it's just descended into YouTube comment section. And, like, the Twitter feed is no one's actually talking to each other. It's just talking at me, and it's all lovely and polite. It's really weird. Any actual questions on there? Apparently, no. Someone says they prefer actual armor over DayZ. Who says that? Procrastinator Ben. Hello, Procrastinator Ben. I'm going to take that as a question, because why not? I prefer armor over DayZ as well. I played a small amount of DayZ, but it wasn't really my thing. I like the idea, the survival elements and stuff. I think it's a great idea, but armor has like a million jets you can spawn at once and have huge air battles in the sky that look really stupid. And hell, I'm one for really sort of stupid stuff. Again, that is stupidity in a serious game, which makes it even funnier. Which is a thing that I apparently am for. Let's go to Twitter. Let's see what we can get. The same people keep tweeting me. I'm going to try and get new people. What have we got? What have we got? What have we got? Harrison Smith says, seeing infinite bottles of beer on the wall to pass time. Okay. Infinite bottles of beer on the wall. Infinite bottles of beer. You take one down and pass it around. Infinite bottles of beer on the wall. Yeah, I don't think that works, actually, as a way to pass time. It's just looping the same words over and over again. So, I do apologise, but I don't think that's going to go... That's not going to go very far. Right. Is that a question? I'm trying to read them in my head before I read them out. I do apologise. Graham Minty says, what are some games you've really enjoyed but haven't made a video for yet? Loads. Fucking loads. Like I've said before, San Andreas, I have tried so hard to make a San Andreas video that just explains how superb San Andreas is, and I failed Vice City. I can't do a lot of Rockstar games. I never really did. I did two GTA 4 videos before I started, like, the challenges that I actually did them in. What else have I done? Psychonauts was failed loads, and then I did a video of it, and then I did a series of it, and then I stopped that series of it because I wasn't... I stopped Psychonauts series because I just wasn't adding anything to the comedy at all. I felt like I was unnecessary. It's sort of... I don't like doing complete stuff. I've tried... I kind of like the Bully series because that was a bit more freeform, and I was okay with Voyager Elite Force, but I didn't really like Psychonauts. So if I ever did it again, I would do it in something open world, something where I can go a bit silly and mental and do my own sort of thing. But I don't think I'm going to do it for now, because I'm just not a big fan of sort of complete stuff. I'm not really a big fan of Let's Plays, to be honest. I know, it's so weird. Oh, my finger came off the accelerator. I'm okay. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of Let's Plays at all. Not even slightly. There's a few people I watch. I like Two Best Friends Play, the edited one that you get on Machinima. What's his face? Rockley Smile, the indie guy. And that's really... Game Grumps. Occasionally I'll sit and watch a bit of games. But I don't really like... That's why I did the sort of... I started Let's Plays, because I didn't really like any of the stuff that was there. So I know, I'm rubbish. I'm the worst. When people are like, oh, who do you like on YouTube? I'm like, oh, all these people. None of them are gamers. Yeah, I know. I don't watch games. I'd rather play games. I mean, I like showing off new games, which is what I really want to push the channel with. So instead of just being like, look, I'm going to complete a game you can go buy now, we're like, look, here's a game you can buy now, and then move on to another one. The challenge is stuff that I do is because I like playing games in new ways, like playing games in ways you wouldn't technically do, like Euro Truck with a, like, playing it speed style. I think that's fun. You know, that's different. I think I really want to promote playing games, but not just playing games. Instead of using a game as a game, use it as a set of mechanics and see what you can do with it. I mean, really, the challenge here is I kind of want to... I know I do silly mods and stuff, but I kind of want to deconstruct how games work, really, with that series. That's sort of my plan for it. I know that sounds sort of pretentious and whatever, but no, it's sort of... I kind of want people to play games differently. That's what I want to do. Play games differently, and... play a lot of really awesome games, really promote indie games and stuff. Like, I've got Gone Home, I just played. I did, the video on Gone Home is so different to how I played Gone Home. Like, as soon as I finished the video, I restarted and then played it properly and had a fantastic time. But, I did a sort of a comedy video. Because I can't just do straight videos anymore. I used to, like, my Overgrowth video I rewatch, and it's so detailed and stuff. But I find that so difficult now because I see so many jokes. and I much prefer comedy and stuff. So I've become a more comedian than Let's Player, and I'm okay with that. And that's sort of the direction I'm going with stuff. I kind of want to be a comedian who points out really awesome games you should spend all your money on. That's what I really want to do. That's sort of my thing. It appears I've got 60 miles on the clock there. If that started at 7:01, I don't know if it did or not. We'll write that down next time it starts. We'll write down where it starts from. But that's pretty fucking good. Doing well. But yeah, no, so I've sort of gone, I'm a comedian, fuck it. Why not? It's what I'm good at. I'm good at being funny. Everybody always said you should be a comedian. I think that's just humouring me more than anything. In fact, even my school said I should be a YouTuber. They gave me this little, there's a pink piece, I remember it now, a pink piece of paper telling me what job I should do. Actually, no, it was a detention slip, wasn't it? Yes. I got detention in school for, and I'm going to quote this because I only ever got one. Well, it's because I was quite the hacker. You know, I don't mean sort of like a script kiddie. I mean, I would just break systems down and try and get into stuff. Not for malicious reasons, just because I was really interested in how computers worked and stuff. So when the school had like their intranet stuff, and I worked out how to get into it, and then I found like a chat program, and then told everybody else how to get in the chat program so we could all secretly chat in lessons and stuff. Because fuck it, that's the sort of shit you do. So I got collared for telling inappropriate jokes over the internet. Was the exact words of my detention slip, which is now my job. Hey, I love that. That's so great. I'm gonna get that. I'm gonna find that. I'm gonna dig that out and frame it. It's gonna be wonderful. But that's true. That is a true story. I wish it wasn't, but it's true. Yeah, no, I used to get some sort of, I was once called away because there was like some not new thing for the school. I can't remember what it was, but I remember getting called out of lessons and then sent to my teacher. So some sort of like teacher would be like, how did you get on this thing? It hasn't opened yet. I was like, oh, I did these things. And they were like, oh. That was really good fun. I like that. I mean, nowadays you can't get away with that. There's that story recently of a kid who hacked into his school stuff to prove how weak it was and then was arrested and jailed for a little while. Yay. talking about school. I like that my happy stories about school involve me getting in trouble and detentions. Oops. I kind of like school. School is a lot of pressure, and it's a hell of a lot more pressure now, considering that everybody lies to you and says that you need to get good grades to be able to do anything in life. That's bollocks. You need to just, the other thing people say is like, oh, just follow your dreams and shit. Well, you have to put fucking effort in. Like, that's the main thing in life. That's the thing I've realised in life, is if you put fucking effort in, you'll get somewhere. I'm shit at giving pep talks, by the way, so don't expect this to be one. And now, as you can see, I'm quickly explaining what I've been doing for absolutely ages. The left cleaner on the window, where it joins the car, I've been trying to slalom that little bit there between the yellow lines to entertain myself. I'm actually still playing the game in my head, which is weird. Pep talk, what was I saying? Pep talk communion. Oh no, because the secret thing is like, because I dropped out of university. I failed a lot of my A levels for various reasons. And I then did like a year of foundation year at university. And I came second in the year during that because I knew the shit, but I kind of got fucked over a bit with my. It doesn't matter. That's a long story. I'm gonna forget. But so I went to like 6% of my lessons or something stupid during the foundation year and still came second because I knew the stuff. I just actually then could do the right exam papers and things. So yeah, I did sort of. It was alright and stuff. Then I got to university and it was just hell. It was just really. I didn't enjoy it. I mean, a lot of people do. I'm going to say this. A lot of people do. But for me, I just kind of wanted to do something else. Because I was sort of... I never questioned anything. That was the thing. Up until university, I never questioned stuff. It was always go to school, go to college, go to university. That's the things we do. And kind of started to go, why am I here? Why am I... Because I studied astrophysics. Yeah, I'm a smart fuck. It doesn't matter. I don't act like it. Because I'm... I don't know. I don't know how you can... Because like, I see people like, oh, I've got an IQ of... I'm like, who gives a shit? But yeah, it's sort of... I was kind of just there doing it one day. Because I did like nanotechnology and stuff. And really... I loved it. I loved the courses and stuff. But I was kind of like a... Why the fuck am I doing this? I don't want a job in this shit. I mean, I'm only here for an interest. And if I stick with this too long, I'm going to get a job in it. I'd much rather go and work in a shop or something. So I dropped out of university with the goal of going to work in a shop. And then, like anybody with a goal of getting a job in this country, I was unemployed for about a year and a half. Quick pro tip. If somebody you know is looking for work, don't ask them how's the job search going. They'll let you know if it's going well, and they don't want to be constantly reminded that it's not. And yeah, just don't fucking, because the amount of shit people get when they're looking for a job, it's the worst thing. It's worse than school. Fuck it, that's how bad looking for a job is. Because you're doing interviews, you're doing all this sort of shit, you're trying to get interviews is the most important thing. Trying to get interviews, trying to get all this sort of thing, and people will be like, oh, you're not doing very much to get a job, just sitting on your ass all day. Those people are cuntbags, and I don't like them at all. It's the worst fucking thing to say to someone who's currently at the lowest ebb ever. It really is. It's just, like, fucking so shitty that you have to, like, rely on the government to try and get you saying, hang on, a sign's coming up! Ooh, drama. Is it a bus sign? Does it say bus? It does. Okay, carry on. But yeah, it's, like, just the fucking... Those people. Seriously. Just don't fucking ask that shit. Oh, how's the job search going? Oh, well, I haven't told you I've got a job, so fucking five guesses. All right? Sorry, that's a personal thing. I'll leave it there. I think I swore quite badly there. It doesn't matter. Swear words are great. Swear words are great. Seriously. I love that people get offended by swear words. Because it's just fucking... How does the word fuck offend you? Like, which bit? Is it the word? Because the word just means sex. If I said the word sex, you wouldn't be offended. If I'm like, oh, sex. Sex that. You'd be like, well, that's a bit weird, but that's not offensive at all. So it's not like the word, like the meaning of the word. Is it the sound? Is duck three quarters offensive? What? I don't understand. Did you hear the word fudge? You're like, what did you say? Oh, I thought some of that was a swear word. No, it's... Society has gone, these words are bad, not allowed to say them. Which is great, because I can say them. I'm not doing anything wrong compared to the other shit you can do in society. I'm not doing anything wrong. And people go, oh, and it's more kind of... It's slightly just a bit shocking. Fuck it. I swear as much as you want. I don't really care. Especially in school. No, don't do that! don't swear in front of authority figures, but yeah. So it's not like swearing makes you cool or anything. They're just really great words because they're powerful. Like earlier when I used the C word, cunt, people went, oh, he fucking said the word cunt, that's a bad thing. But it's a solid word. I mean, that, it's a real sit up and listen word. It's got that power. And I really like that people find it sort of, like, shitty and people are like, oh, it does find it shitty, fantastic. But no, people find it sort of like, you know, offensive and stuff because it's a great word of power. Like, because I don't take a lot of offense to it. It's not like a direct offense. It's just a word. There's limits to how, like, offensive you can say. There are some words that, like, aren't offensive unless directed at someone. Like, faggot. I hate the word faggot. I would never use the word faggot. But me saying the word faggot isn't, like, an insult or direct to anyone. So I can clearly say the word faggot right now. And no one is going to get offended. Fucking some people might get offended. But you shouldn't get offended because I'm just using a word. If I shout at someone like, yeah, you faggot, that's offensive. That's a bad thing. It's the same reason if you call someone a cunt, then it's kind of, I don't know, there's sort of a difference in my head. Like, I find the word faggot more offensive than, like, any other swear word, because its primary use is to go at people. The word fuck is versatile. You can use that in so many situations, and only, like, a few of them. Like, at people, like, ah, you fucking idiot. But that's actually not particularly offensive. Fucking idiot is sort of fine, but stuff. But calling someone a faggot is straight out offensive. Like, it's a really bad word, and it's sort of, it's not really that, it's weird. It's sort of how I view swear words. It's so different to how everybody else does. I think that's cool. There's an insight. There's a weird insight. But I, Christ knows what question got me on that. Oh, blasphemy, 10 points. Blasphemy. Sorry. I do love the tangle. They're like my favorite thing. Everybody's like, oh, if you follow the Ten Commandments, you'll be set for life. What? There's like a few of these, like, don't talk shit about this guy. That's what they are. They're like, don't be bad about God. Make sure he's your favorite God. Like, there's nothing in there about, like, you know, don't just bludgeon people over the head with spoons and all the other stuff that you're not supposed to. They're quite bad for rules. And there's 13 of them if you read the Bible, so I don't understand. Why is that? That's a history thing. Why is that 10 becomes 13? Like, there are 10, like, 13 commandments, but they've become the 10 commandments. Like, that's how they're referred to and stuff. But then there was, like, the 100 Years War, but that lasted, like, 130 years. 10 becomes 13 in history. That's because history works in a different base of mathematics. True story. How weird would that be? History just works in base 13. Oh, hang on. I'm now trying to work out what mathematical sum would be 42 in base 13. And I don't want to be honest. That's maths I don't... See, that's the stuff my brain does. And I don't want it to do that anymore. I'm done with school. What was I was talking about school. I was talking about something. Work. I worked in a call center. I worked in this call center. I don't think I ever sold anything, but I became like IT support pretty fucking quickly in that place because I was quite good with computers. Yeah, fun fact about IT support. You get in there because you like fixing computers. You're going to be dealing with people and having to fix people, not computers. It's the worst thing about that job, is that you're like, oh my god, I get to fix computers. I love fixing computers. It's easy. This is going to be fantastic. I'm going to get paid for it. And then morons will call you up with, like, stupid fucking shit that they don't just... You're just like, how do you not know this? How are you not doing this? The keyboard won't type. Is it plugged in? How do I know? Oh, God. Like, because my plan when I dropped out of university, I think that's what I was getting on there, was sort of, like, get a job. And I sort of got these other job stuff. But it was always sort of a, I'll do this for a little while. But, like, the back of my mind was, I'm going to go and get, like... I kind of always wanted to become an electrician. Is that weird? Because I, as a kid, it was always a pilot. I always wanted to be a pilot, and then I have shit eyes, and they're like, you can't be a pilot. I was like, oh, fuck that. And I'm kind of glad I'm not a pilot now, because it's fucking terrifying. Sorry, just from what I play on, like, it's, flying itself isn't terrifying, because I know physics. But, like, playing flight simulators and stuff, I don't have the patience for flying. I have the patience for this, apparently, though, so that's good. But I always wanted to be, like, electrician or plumber or something, because that's, like... That's, like, a real thing. That's, like, something that'll always be necessary. And, like, all the jobs that get created now are in that sort of field, and no one's going to do those things. It's sort of really weird. So if this YouTube ever packs in, fuck it, I'm going to go become an electrician. I'd love that job. I would love problem-solving and smashing people's houses up without smashing people's houses up too much. It just sounds fantastic. Sounds great fun. And also plumber. I'd love to be a plumber. I really like those sort of hands-on jobs. Just so weird. Considering, like, I love writing as well. Ah, fuck it. Life's great. There are so many jobs out there. When people are like, oh, I'm just going to work in an office. You don't really have to work in an office. I mean, I didn't like working in an office. I couldn't stand it. Within 5 hours, had decided I was quitting. And then, actually, within 5 hours, I'd started doodling a Minecraft comic that somehow turned out okay. So, yeah, it was, some people really like office work, like really love office work. I mean, you don't know until you try, really. I thought I'd really like it. I didn't like it. I really, really love working in shops. Like, working in a shop is just like one of the best things. I find it so intense. Because I used to work in this little sweet shop, which was like great. It was quite fun and sort of normal and stuff and that. And then, like, lunchtime would come and the kids would just come pelting out of school. Just like come and get sweets, and then after school, just fucking bedlam, and that bedlam was just so great, just doing maths really quickly and handing out shit. I really like that. It's probably why I like Papers, Please so much, I don't know. But, yeah, like, there's so many. When people are like, oh, there's no jobs open to me and stuff, there are, and fucking, they're great. I mean, what's that show? Is it Dirty Jobs? The guy who does Dirty Jobs does a great TED talk on how, like, dirty jobs make you feel. Just like really, not just like going like, oh, I'm so glad I don't have that life, but like these are the happiest people on the planet who do these jobs because they're genuinely doing something that's changing a lot. I think that's what I really like. I'd like a job that changes day to day, not just sort of like working in an office. But that's just me. I mean, anyone does anything. I really thought I would hate all work when I was in school. I'd be like, oh, I don't want to do any of these things. But I sort of tried stuff and then sort of, I like it. I kind of like everything. I really just like being a jack of all trades, really. I just like doing things. I fucking hate relaxing. I think that's the general thing. I can't stand relaxing. I will just be sitting, like, just somewhere. And it'll be like, oh, just relax for a bit. And I'm like, what? I could be doing work right now. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing. Anyway, that was a small rant about absolutely everything. Let's get some more questions from Steam Group. We are so sorry, skeletons. You're so misunderstood. You only want to socialize, but I don't think we should. From Tilly TM. Toads to Twitter! Okay, right. What are we doing? Lots of people. Keep moving. It's so hard to like try and drive. Okay, we'll just see what we've got there. Someone missed the bus to school today. Who's that? Mad Ben Gaming. Apparently missed the bus to school today, and can I pick him up in yours? Well, if you leave between... Where's this game set? Is it Tuscan? Tuscan? Something like that? This... about Tuscan or something in Las Vegas. If you go to school between there, then yeah, sure. Unfortunately, this bus is virtual, as is the road, as is the two places, so it really didn't matter very much. I used to get the bus to school, man. That was hell. not a public bus, like a school bus. But like our school buses are double-deckers driven by mental patients. That's how bus drivers in England are scary. I hate the bus. Like, if someone's like, oh, just get the bus, I'm like, oh, God. Like, trains. Fucking love trains. That's I like trains. No, don't crash into me. I like, trains are great, because just fucking, you scan your shit and you get on. That's great. I like that sort of thing. But buses are just like, even though you scan your shit and get on, they're sort of effort. Like, really terrifying effort. But the school bus we used to have was a double-decker big thing. But if it was the guy who was doing it ever ran late, which was like most days, he would just go fucking 90 miles per hour in this double-decker. And there was this turn we would get up to, because like it was a mostly straight road we would go down, and then there was a turn before we got to the school. But it was a really sharp turn, and this dude would do it at speed. So we'd all have to like fucking go to one side of like the bus, because it would like fucking lean on two wheels. Oh man, that was fucking hilarious. I like how all my school stories are like outside of school. I always say school was like the worst time ever, and it kind of was because of all the pressures and stuff. But, like, generally good people and things. It's not... there's, like, kids are fuckheads. Like, 90% of the kids... Not 90%, that's far too high. It's 10%. 90% of the kids you meet are great. Like, they're just normal stuff. But there's 10% of kids who are just fuckheads. Who will just try and ruin absolutely fucking everything. And, unfortunately, the human mind, for some reason, fucking ignores criticism... ignores compliments. And just fucking homes in on criticism. Just fucking homes right on in there. And you just feel just fucking shitty. It's just, I fucking hate those 10%. Fucking bullies, man. If you're a fucking bully, fuck off. You are fucking meaningless. You are the scrotum on the sun of life, burning and blistering and being quite painful. You are useless, nobody wants you, and you smell like burnt testicles. That's true. That's, if you, don't be fucking mean, even if you think, like, just a kid, oh, he's weird, fuck you. You're weird. You're the one who's fucking being an antisocial fuckwit. This is getting slightly more ranty. Slightly more ranty than I thought. What are we? I seem to be stuck talking about school. I think it's because I'm in a bus and it's reminiscing, because I used to sit quite close to the front, because I used to chat the mentally insane bus drivers. That's always fun. I love the days when the bus didn't turn up, though. That's just, like, the greatest moment. Like, because, like, after... like, because school starts at 9. If the bus hasn't turned up by 9, the bus has failed you. Fucking day off. Was how I assumed, like, the rules were. The bus would always arrive at 8:59 and, like, 50 seconds. That's just when that fucking bus would arrive. Just every fucking day. It would you'd still be late for school, but I was always on the last fucking stop, so it would never bloody miss my... anyway, what's going on? Scott Manley of Kerbal Space Fame, the guy who have you seen the stuff Scott Manley does? Like, he actually knows how to play Kerbal Space Program. Like, because I have done some good stuff. Like, I launched the other day a rocket from the launch pad, landed it on the moon, and then launched it off of the moon and landed it back on the launch pad. Like, that was fucking amazing. This guy can fucking do that across every fucking planet. And at the same time, launching like new satellites in every single orbit. So he's a fucking wizard. He says that someone should play Desert Bus on an actual bus while doing this ride. That would be awful. I mean, like, I get bored on buses, but doing this as well. Although, what would be superb is I think there is actually an Android version of Desert Bus. Like, I think there is an Android version. That you can get. Don't count me on that one. I know there's the browser version, but I think someone made an Android version you could play. Interesting. You could buy it because all the proceeds went to Desert Bus. That was the charity at Desert Bus. Penn and Teller just get some money every now and then. Like, what the fuck is this? We're not a charity. That was a real thing. What was I saying? I can't remember. Excuse me, a bug went in my mouth. That's actually not glass there. That's open. It's just constant dust in my eyes. I'm doing this with my eyes closed. True story. Christ, it's warm. My computer's actually cooling down, even though I'm warm, which is weird. Right, who are we gonna talk to now? We've got stop veering. Hoggy 110 says, if you could have one superpower, then is there other reasons you pick speed up time? What? Anyway, if I could have one superpower. I would have... what do I have as my superpower? I would like the ability to modify molecules, like to the atomic level, but like universe-wide. Like, I could just do fucking anything then. That's just the thing. Like, telekinesis, but of individual molecules. And then I could sort of, like, train up to be able to do loads of stuff. So, like, to start, I could, like, move some air around, and then later on I could, like, boil tea. And then after that, I could, like, stop time and just freeze them all. It'd be great. I think that would be... Actually, the temperature would drop and the universe would implode if I did that, wouldn't they? I don't know. I think I would always love telekinesis, because telekinesis, like, the... Wait, hang on. Which is the one that lets you read minds? Which is the one that lets you float stuff? Telekinesis? And what's the other one? Telepathy? Telekinesis. That's a song, isn't it? Telekinesis is the one where you get to move shit around with your hands, isn't it? Or mind, or whatever. Hat. No, Dan, moving shit around with your hand is just known as picking shit up. No, I would do the... Because telekinesis, like, lets you move shit, which is great, because I'm lazy. But it also means you can fly, because you can fly yourself. Ah, you don't just go... People who just go fly, I'm like, wrong. I could do funny stuff. Actually, I wouldn't like to speed. I like to slow down time, but let my computer still run. I think that would be cool. I would love the ability to do, like... loads of videos a day, but you wouldn't be able to watch them all day. Like, I'd love to edit a video every day and still like sleep and stuff, so like make 2 days. That's what I would love. I'd like to have like go at half time, so I'd be going like twice as fast, so time would be slowed down for me, like half speed, so then I would be able to do a full edited video every single day. I would love that. That would be my thing right now. That's what I want to do. Yeah, the other superpower I would like, what else would I like? X-ray vision, and then getting a job as a doctor. Do you reckon like X-ray vision people just like go around just giving everyone cancer, like, because they just two of the X-rays just radiating people? That would be weird. There's probably a dark comic book that deals with that. I'm not a fan of like the dark comic books and stuff. I'm more of a fan of the 9 o'clock. I'm more of a fan of the sort of lights. I don't really like comic books, to be honest, because they're all confusing and weird. But I love comic book movies, and I love the comic book movies that comic book geeks hate, like comic book geeks. Yeah, even I call you geeks. Comic book geeks is like a phrase. That's just, it's comic book geeks and computer nerds, isn't it? And I'm a computer nerd, and you're comic book geeks. I love geeks and nerds and stuff. I didn't take part in Geek Week, I'll take part in Nerd Week. But, yeah, so sort of comic book movies. Like, Iron Man 3 was hated by fans of Iron Man. I think Iron Man 3 is so far the best film of the year. With second place and third place being, like, Ashen's and the Quest of the Game Child and The Croods. That was a fantastic film. But I loved Iron Man 3, but so many people were like, oh my god, they got rid of the... Oh, what was his name? The... Satsuma. No, that's... Oh, Mandarin! God, Satsuma, you fucking moron. Yeah, because he was, like, apparently some sort of big deal in the Marvel Universe, and he's not in the movie because he's not, like, really magic or anything. So I really liked the film. I thought it was great, but the comic book people didn't like it. I don't remember what point I was going on with that, or what the question was. Christ on a bike, I'm not paying attention. Anyway, 9 o'clock, let's have another jelly bean. Let's go for this one here. This jelly bean here is orange, but it's got a lot, sort of red marbly effect on it. So it's got like extra bits of red all the way around it. So it's orange and red. Let's have a try of this one. Oh, peach! Instant! Very nice. That is a very nice jelly bean, that one. Nice and sweet. No aftertaste, no acid. Not sour. Good jelly bean. Good jelly bean, that one. Yeah, okay. Have we got any more of them? No, fuck. Ah, shite. Alright. I'm going to have a quick drink. Woo! What was I going to say? I can't remember. School. Just talking about school, aren't I? That's what this first one will be. This first one will be school, and I'll move on to middle life. Then my crisis, and then old age, and then I'll die at the end of this. I hope I can. GTA 5's giving out soon. Let's get some more questions. Why not? Still sane, says Danny O'Brien. I think I'm holding out there. This is actually going a lot smoother than I thought it would. People have kept me a bit sane. Oh my god, when I said that, I spat jelly bean out, and it's got between the cracks on my keyboard. Oh no! It's between the control and the shift. I don't think they're buttons. Hang on, I gotta extract that. Oh my god, it's gone in! Is that cool? The game is still running fine. Okay, right. Ready? Get that. Oh, because I can't click the other button on, because that's like the right click. Oh. I'm going to use a post-it note to get that little bit out. Ha 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 ha. Coming. Oh, fantastic. Right there we go. Okay, let's put that on the bin over there. I'll stick the in my post-it note down there. Whoa, veering. I'm veering. Wait, good. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of silence in my videos. Like, that. It's sort of, I like, a silence that's just a bit too long. I'm not a big fan. I always stop a video if it's got too much of a silence, unless it's like a comedy silence or needed silence. But like in gaming videos, when someone's like, "Hi and welcome to this game." Talk! I mean, like, it's just, it's not the... it's not the hardest thing to do in the world. How's my... Sorry, I need to get a bit close. I need to get a bit close to my microphone to read the thing. We have... Oh, dear. Not a lot of time left to record. That's, I've got about half an hour left to record, which is fantastic. So it's taking up a little bit more than normal because I'm doing lots of talking. That's okay. That's okay. Because normally when I'm doing my edited stuff, I'll talk for a bit and then stop, and then talk for a bit and then stop. And so I'd sometimes do rambles and stuff, but then I edit them down. But there are a lot of pauses and gaps. Unedited videos, I don't really let go beyond like 20 minutes or so. So it seems that's going to take some sort of thing. Let's get a question from the... What do we want? Twitter! No, let's do Steam. Okay. What have we got? Let's just see what... There's absolutely nothing. We're just talking to each other. It's quite nice to see people, because like now it's simmered down a bit. It's quite nice to see people actually chatting and stuff and having good fun. Oh, that's someone's name I can't even slightly pronounce. Colin's Beast. It looks like Colin's Beast, but with numbers and letters and something else in front of it. It's like a comma equals comma B. Fuck it. I'm staying here the full 8 hours. I'm with Dan, smiley face. Thank you. Please get a name that's pronounceable. It's like got brackets and shit. I never get... That's like clans and stuff here, isn't it? If you have a bracket before, you know. I don't know that sort of thing. What else have we got? 5 seconds film is cool. So survivalist. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yes, I do like 5 second films. You ever seen 5 second films? They're dudes who make dudes and dudesettes. When I say dudes, I just generally mean a group of people. That's just a turn of phrase that I've always used. I just mean a group of people is dudes. You know, I just... Is that weird? Is that sexist? I don't know. I'm probably sexist at some point. Sexism is the new thing, isn't it? In YouTube and games and stuff. That's the thing we're currently focused on, which is good. I like that. I think that's a good thing to focus on. Try and get equality. Because I'm fucking... Actually, I hate the word feminist because people have really destroyed the use of that word recently. I am the original use of the word feminist, which means I want equality for all. That's what I want. If there's a better word for that, equalist. That's it. Why not? That probably just means like Hitler fan or something like that. But I just want everybody to be equal in life, no matter what you're born in. Just you start and then fucking everybody's on the same footing. That's sort of my goal, and that's where we're going to work towards. That's what I want the human race to be. Like, it doesn't matter what your fucking skin color is or what you want to do in bed or who you want to do it with or whatever. As long as it's just fucking I hate people who don't like gays. Like, it just. Fucking why? Sorry. I'll calm down before I get on that rant. I'm calm. Good, time to rant. So, it's just this whole fucking, like, Russia and shit. Fucking Russia at the moment are the ones who really... They've just pushed anti-gay laws that you're not allowed to promote homosexuality or anything. It's a natural fucking thing. Animals are just gay. You get gay animals. It's a survival thing. Like, if I recall correctly, Christ knows where I remember reading this, but it was it's better off if, like, the later born children are gay, because that means that they won't fight for dominance, which would damage the family unit in big groups and stuff. So it makes sense that the latter ones would be gay, because then they wouldn't breed and compete and stuff. That's the point of it. That's what it is. It's also kind of a population control thing. There's loads of theories into what it could possibly be, but it is just... shit that's in your head, and that's just how you're wired. It's just a normal thing. But it seems to be... People don't really get in an uproar when people are against it. I mean, if these people were going, "Oh, blacks, don't give them jobs, we should be able to discriminate against them," people would lose their fucking minds. But this is okay, because it covers a fucking spectrum, a rainbow, if you will. I don't like this. The human race is getting better. Everything is getting better. This is a fact. I know everybody fucking hates the universe. I'm like, "Oh no, woe is me, everything's worse." No. Everything is getting better. Like, crime rate's down, everything is down, tolerance is there. So, tolerance, like, if you're not tolerant, it just stands out more now. That's what really, it's so you get like Russia just promoting these stupid fucking laws. And you get places like Uganda where it's legal to like just kill gay people. fuck? They're just backwards. You just seem so fucking backwards. The rest of the world isn't going to follow suit, and you're eventually going to break down from it. I don't know. It irks me. I just want everyone to just be like, you're born. You're this person. You have these attributes. Go and live life. You have the same footing as everyone else. That would be wonderful. Wouldn't that? We're all in this together, like Mr. David Cameron says, before giving tax breaks to the rich and increasing the tax on the poor. Like the cunt muffin he is. I generally don't use the word cunt in videos. Like, I try and stay away from it because it's so... I like using it, like, when it's really powerful and stuff. But I've decided to lax that today because I've realised 6 people are watching this. And they can all enjoy this with me. I just want equality, guys. That's all I want. Equality. Everyone just gets the same start. And you put the effort in and that's what you get. Star Trek, to be perfectly honest. Star Trek is my vision of the future. There's no money in Star Trek. Like, the Earth has no money anymore. People just do the things they want to do, and everything balances out because everybody does the things. So you don't... a captain isn't paid more than any other people. They just have to control a ship and things. There's no money in it. So getting rid of money is just the best first step. I don't know. Let's not go into my half-baked political ideas. Just all I know about politics is I hate all of them. I'm moving country to avoid them. That's true. I am, actually. I don't think England is going to... Sorry, the UK... Or is it England? People get so pissy at this. They're like, oh, it's England, oh, it's the UK, it's Britain. I honestly forget which ones are which, so I generally just mean the ones that David Cameron's in control of. Which may soon not be Scotland. They may vote for independence, which I I don't like people going off independent. I would like everybody to be sort of groupy and happy and stuff. But then, fuck it, I would try and get away from David Cameron, to be perfectly honest. I really like the... I've lost my train of thought. I do like it. That's it. I think the government in this country is going to fuck the internet up. So I'm getting out now before they do. And I'm going to places... I'm looking at a few countries. I'm moving country. That is true. I'm not going to go to America because of your NSA is the scariest fucking thing in the world. Spying on every single person and it's legal? Okay, no thank you. Because I went to America. Oh, fuck. Figure out the accelerator. I went to America. And you are the nicest talkative people I've ever met in my entire life. You talk in elevators. That freaked me the fuck out. Like, in England, elevators are just fucking silent. If you get up an elevator, even if you're with someone you know, you fucking shut up. It's just, it's too close. Too close. People in thing were like, oh my god, hi, how's VidCon? That was my attempt at an American accent. I'll never do it again. I can't do an American accent at all. That's alright, wasn't it? They're like, oh my god, it's like totally VidCon. How are you enjoying it? I'm like, it's great. Really not even like the people in the shops. Like, I went to a corner shop and the people in the shop were like really friendly, like, oh my god, like, have a good day, what are you here for? Oh, I like your accent. And like, what the fuck, this is so cool. It's right. I see why you guys like America now, like, where America's like, hey, we're the best. You're not the best. I mean, the numbers will prove it, but like, education, all that sort of shit, you're really quite low. But you're great. I was really surprised by... It's fucking lovely out there. Especially fucking Disneyland, which is just magical. Even McDonald's. We went to a McDonald's, and the people behind the counters had smiles, and... If you didn't have the NSA shit, and shitty governments, and spy drones, and massive armies, and everyone hated you in the world, I would consider America. It's a very nice place. I'm genuinely surprised by it. I'm assuming it's not like that everywhere, but this was like LA. This was just out of LA, so I assumed it'd be America's quite good. I don't know. I'm sort of looking at Northern Europe is where I'm going. Where it's liberal, it's cold and liberal is what I sort of like. I like liberal politics. I like the everybody should be alone, pay more tax so things actually work. I'm a fan of that. I generally think that's the thing that works. I don't mind paying a bit more tax if, for instance, your roads all work and you have health and schools and stuff. I mean, you look at all the places, like in most parts there, like, universities, like, either free or like the tiniest amount of dollars ever, or euros, sorry, or whatever they have. So it's just so that's kind of where I want to be. And they have like internet laws, they have pirate parties and internet laws that like fucking freedom and shit, and that's sort of what I want. I mean, I think the internet is the future of everything, so yeah. That's what I'm thinking. I'm, whatever. just looked at the time. Only 15 minutes left before I have to change my SD card over. This is going to be good. What I'm going to do is I'm just literally change the SD card over and start back up as quickly as possible. So, because if you stop this, it crashes. So there may be like a 1 minute gap that you'll miss. But I don't think it'll be too much. We're getting there. This has gone slightly well, okay. Ooh, Freddie Wong just put up the next episode of Video Game High School, which I'm not particularly interested in. I love Freddie W's videos. Really, really love Freddie W's videos. And I don't like Video Game High School because it's not a Freddie W video. It's good, but it's not sort of why I was watching Freddie W, so I've sort of just given up on it, really. I liked his old stuff when it was just him doing silly things for special effects, and that's sort of gone now, which is quite sad. But, it's what he wants to do. I mean, fuck it. It's what he wants to do. Jesus, go for it. I mean, loads of people love it. I'm a tiny person, and it's still good stuff. I mean, Video Game High School's solid, but it's just not really for me. So there we go. That's a small thing about Twitter. Twitter? It was from Twitter. Let's go to the YouTube thing. My God. Anything that is aimed at me. Nothing. It's really just no questions at me. They're all just talking about Kerbal Space Program at the moment. It's really simmered down, like from the spammy chat stuff. Oh, it's so adorable. They're just sort of all getting together. Oh, so cute. Right, let's go on Twitter, where things are going over here. Opinions on Payday 2, pros and cons, please. I kind of want to leave that for my video, but it's a good game that I got bored of before I did anything with, really. I wouldn't recommend it unless you have a group of close friends to play. It's very much a game that strangers online are playing to win, because that's the way the game's set up. Like, I don't really like online games that are set to win. I mentioned this a bit earlier on, but sort of if you've got, say, Battlefield 3. Like, that's what I want. I don't like individual statistics. Like, leveling up yourself. I don't think that should be done. I think you should, like, level up as a team, or somehow, or level up, like, your teamwork and things. So I kind of want to, instead of, like, forcing people who are like, oh, I need to level up my jets, I'll just fly around a jet for the whole thing and not really help very much. I kind of want people who, well, an online game that focuses on praising teamwork instead of what they currently do, which is praising your work and then sort of hope you play as a team. Sort of forcing that teamwork through the leveling and stuff. I think that's something that things should do. Payday 2 was, single player is awful. Don't play it single player. It barely functional as a single player game. Multiplayer, you just need people to play it with, and I don't really have that. Some of the levels are good. It's a lot smaller scale than the last one. The last one was a lot bigger scale, so it feels kind of weird. And I think they're going to add more levels of DLC and stuff. I'm not really that interested. Some of the levels are very poor. Mall Crasher, for existence, is not very well explained and is really self-explanatory. I mean, you're supposed to like do $50,000 of damage in this mall in a very short amount of time. But you can't. It doesn't tell you how much damage you're doing, or if things you're shooting at are actually damage. I mean, like, you go in there and you get a sports car, so I've got explosives as my character, so I strap explosives to the sports car and blow it up and it dents and the windows smash and stuff, and apparently that's not a lot of damage. That doesn't instantly go for the 50,000. And then I get an update like, oh, you've done 1,500 bit of damage. I'm like, oh, really? But that's another failing of the AI on that one, because the AI can't shoot out windows. In fact, you only get two AI instead of the three as well, which I always found quite weird. Anyway, enough about Payday 2. I will save that through the thing. Are you worried about falling asleep mid-video? Asks Alexis Jeffrey. Oh, did I say the name of who did the last one? Oh, bugger, I think I missed it. I do apologise. No, I got up only an hour ago before I started recording, before I did this, or two. So I should be awake. I've been quite sleepy recently, but my sleeping pattern's all over the place, and I'll stay up for this. I will have to get food at some point. Christ knows how I'm going to do that. I don't think the jelly beans will be able to sustain me. Let's actually do the last jelly bean of this episode now, before I have to do the break. This is a green one again, sort of the same colour as the last one, but it's got little white flecks all over it. So either it's something that's green and white, which I can't really think of, or someone's attempted to tip X it out. No idea. Shower one. Oh, bloody hell. Ugh. Yes, that's not quite nice. I have no clue what that is. No clue at all. flavoured. Okay, part of me likes the idea that some people like sort of like just leaning in a bit close, kind of tense as to what flavour it really was. I really have no idea. It's sort of, lime, maybe? Tastes like pear again, to be totally honest. So, maybe it'll taste like pear. I don't know. It's not very good, that one. I've got another one of it to eat later on as well. Mm. Oh well. What do we do now? We got 10 minutes left of this episode. Should wrap things up for the first bit. Oh, bloody hell. So yeah, I'm going to stop recording. Did I start? Yes, I did. Sorry, new mic. I don't know if it's recording yet. Yeah. I'll stop recording and then I will move things off of... Oh no, I've got spare SD cards, so I'm just going to plug another SD card in and start again. So that shouldn't take too long, but I do need to break it up. Especially because uploading to YouTube, for me, takes forever. And it takes longer, like, the longer your videos are, it takes more time, like, seems exponentially. So I don't want to break a 2-hour video. Like, the Eurotrip one took about, I think it was 12 hours to upload. And an 8-hour video, I did, like, a test 8-hour video, and it was coming in, like, 2-3 weeks, as far as I could see. So if I do 4 2-hour videos, well, 3 2-hour videos, and then one, however long that last one is, I think that should be good. That's the plan. We have another 20 minutes left. So yeah, this is going quite well. I've just been ranting about stuff. It's like a podcast. I should just break this up into 30-minute episodes and then I'd be done for an entire series. let's get one more question from the Twitter. Oh, unless Steve's doing anything. Oh, come on. Hang on, just going to budge over. What have we got? Nothing. There's apparently some duck talk going on, but apart from that, there's nothing. Apparently there's people in the voice chat that is just living hell, so that's nice. Is Dan still playing Desert Bus? Asked Medal of Halo. Yes, I am. Yes, I am, and yes, I will be for another, what is it now, 6 hours, 10 minutes? 2 hours done. I mean, that's impressive. But it doesn't feel... I just like talking about myself, really, I suppose. Well, because, I mean, normally I throw on a bit of a sort of silly character-esque thing. But, no, this seems to go... This is more a bit me. Ooh, it's quite intimate, isn't it? And so this was my 500th video. The next one will obviously be video 501. It will be up... If you've been watching this video from when I just uploaded it, it will be up straight after, because I'm going to be uploading these today, Saturday, when I'm recording this, and I'm putting these up Monday. So, I'm going to put them up every 2 hours. So the next part should be up by the time you finish watching this, whenever this goes up. I don't know when I'm going to put these up. I was sort of thinking I kind of want to finish at sort of 8. So no, sorry, finish 10. So the last episode at 8. So 6 for 2. Is that right? 2 p.m. UK time. So early morning America. Yeah, maybe a bit later than that then. Yeah, no, I'll finish at midnight. Why not? We'll finish at midnight. So we'll have episode 4 starts at 10. 8 for episode 3, 6, and then 4. So it'll start at 4 p.m. I don't know. You've already seen these fucking things. I thought I'm telling you this. This is not for you. I should make a note of that. But yeah. Right. The air freshener is spinning. 9 minutes left. The only downside is the... don't know when the end is. So the last one's going to get a bit tense, really, and a bit less discussion-y. Oh, my bloody legs ache. I think I'm going to stretch my legs a bit before I do anything else. And I realise I've been moving around as I talk quite a lot, so I apologise for the sound. Ooh, very nearly crashed then. No, I have the ball. I'll be honest, I'm starting to feel a little heavy under the eyes. Just a little bit sort of... But I think we'll be okay. And I'm getting a little quieter because I can feel my voice just slightly not working. That's the end. 8 minutes left. Of this episode. What should we? Who should we? What should we? Who should we? Philip Shaddix. Is that Shaddix? Whoop, crap. Ask, what is your favourite YouTube video of all time? This one. No, I've got no. I don't know. I mean, favourites are so weird. I got, like, loads that I like. I like, oh, actually... I think I do have. I really like Nathan J. Barnett's Comment une enfant. Christ, that was French. I can't really say it. It's one of his remix dance videos that he did. I really like that video. That is a beautiful video. It makes me so goddamn happy whenever I watch it. The downside, however, is that it's been blocked in the UK because somebody owned something about it or something. And I don't know if it's blocked anywhere. There is someone else has uploaded it, so I've downloaded my own copy of it. But that's like my favourite YouTube video, even though it's technically not on his YouTube channel anymore. Even though it is just been blocked or something by twat managers. Yeah, that's sort of... No, it's this. Fuck it. This is my favourite YouTube video of all time. I got to talk about school and things and other stuff. Next time, I'll tell you about my teachers and about my jobs and about nothing. I think that's the only thing that happens in school is that there was a lot of shit going on. There's a lot of stories to tell about it. So even if overall I was like, oh God, why won't it end? I suppose there's just a bit more to talk about in it, really. I don't know. It's sort of, it's like when you get to university, all people talk about, like, if you ever meet somebody, because A-levels just got the results, didn't they? So some of you are going to be toddling off to university soon. I sold that really well to you guys. You'll meet some people who the only thing they'll do is talk about their A-level results. Like, at the start, that'll be your icebreaker, is talk about your A-level results. What did you get? Oh. But there are some people who don't stop talking about their A-level results. Don't be one of those people. Don't be one of those people. Nobody likes that person. No, especially when they're still the smartest person in the bloody class afterwards. But yeah, we got 5 minutes left. Oh, 6 minutes left. My hand is... Oh my God. Can you hear that? Ah, clicky. That's horrible. So horrible. I've started to really not pay attention to the game, I'll be honest. I'm starting to lose that a little bit. But I think we'll be okay. Look how gorgeous this game looked. I mean, oh. Actually, Sega CD, everyone. Penn & Teller's Smoke and Mirrors. I was tempted to call the video Nerky Plays Penn & Teller's Smoke and Mirrors, but I'm not playing the whole of it, I'm just playing Desert Bus, so this is a mini game in a little game. You've learned that today. Yeah. 8 hours. There's no pause as well. Can I point that out to you? There's no pause. So anything I do, I'll have to still be driving when I do. You cannot pause this. It hates you. But anyway, yeah, the quality was a bit shitty. I do apologise for that. It's not a lot. And, yeah. 5 minutes to go. I sort of wanted to just wrap this up now. Put my feet up. Just relax. Ah! Stretch. A squeaky, squeaky chair. Oh, it's the stretch. Stretch right now so I can get onto the next part with vigour and enthusiasm. And by vigour, I don't mean the magic powers that you get in Power Shop. Fuck it, let's have one more jelly bean. What should we go for? This one here. It appears to be a light grey. Christ knows what this is going to be. It is. Sour. Ugh. There is no flavour. That's weird. It just tastes sour. Yeah. Oh, hang on. Nope. It's sort of like little flavours hidden away from me. Just tastes sour. Oh, it's a bit butterscotchy when you go, maybe it's sour butterscotch? Ew. Oh, if you're interested, this video is now 8.2 gigabytes. And as I break my videos up every 4 gigabytes normally, that's about maybe a minute. I can't remember the maths now. It's about a minute of standard recording. I've done 2 hours in time to do a minute. I hope the quality isn't too shit. Oh God, that was a little lower than I thought that would be. But yeah, that'll be okay. But yeah, this resolution, I can record for 8 gig in, say, 2 hours. Because actually, I've been recording 2 hours, so I recorded a little bit at the start as well. 8 gig in 2 hours is about, what, 2,500 hours I record? Yeah, let's not do that. Let's not do that. Dark Truth Gaming says, don't crash, Dan! Don't crash! Okay, I won't. I have people asking if I've crashed already. I haven't crashed already. You know this. You're all seeing this. Yeah. Let's now talk to the Steam chat. The fuck are you guys on? Sorry, I do lose it when I eat the jelly bean. I gotta eat the jelly bean quicker. That's what we've learned here. I'll learn this sort of stuff now. Oh, I like that. Ask a... What the fuck? Oh, shit. Yo, we get spam. Ask a... Parla on Dorato says, or something like that, says, we are all but the falling leaves in the Garden of Dan. What the fuck does that mean? Oh, I quite like that. Okay, 2 minutes to go. Someone's decided to do the copy-pasta of the Navy SEAL thing, because they have no intelligence or funniness. So I am slightly insulting people now. Fuck it, I'm starting to feel the burn. 6 hours left to go. 2 hours done. Oh, God. I might order a pizza at some point and hope they deliver it through my window.
Can you throw 27 stories in the air?
No.
Oh. Okay.
Okay. Oh, my God. I do like the, sorry. Someone says that Dan is streaming this. Press LTF4 to go there now. It's like in Counter-Strike when you tell people push button. Is it F11 or something? Like, how do I do the voice chat? Oh, press this. It was like a instant quit out of the game button. That was hilarious. Oh, that was a great thing. It's just like, so I was like, how do I chat? And then like, oh, you push this button. And there's like buzzing. It's disconnected. And you get all laugh. That's the fun of online gaming. I like Counter-Strike's online gaming as well. 1 minute left. Right. I will wrap this up. In the next part, I will be talking about whatever the box I can come up with. I'm sort of out of... I didn't really write anything down. I just thought I could wing this. Really. We've done 98 miles on the clock. I think I'll write down that number when we start the next one. But from me, this shouldn't take too long. I really want to do this quickly so I can just get straight on there. But I do want to end these properly. So from me and the desert bus, after 2 hours, thanks for watching, procrastinators, and I'll see you now. Really? Next. In fact, just there'll just be a link. A new video will appear when this one goes up. So, yeah. Come on, tick away. Oh, I timed this so wrong. I want to end it with a yeah, and that'll be like it, and then I'll be like 9:30. You've betrayed me once again, clock. You've betrayed me. I haven't even checked if that clock's going at the right time. Oh, fuck. Well, hang on, it's gone now. I should end this episode. I'll talk about that for next time. Till next time. Till part two, which is here. Well, not. You won't. That link won't work until it's here. But it's here. Fuck it. Ta-ra.